It's time for the Mark Bless Show on Audio Sports Online. The Mark Bless Show is brought to you by Reynolds Body Shop, McNamara Florist, Red Cobra Wrestling, Citywide Paving, Changes Home Care, and Avon Dental Care. Now it's time to talk to the head coach of the Avon Orioles, Coach Mark Bless. The Avon Orioles began last Friday night's contest with the Westfield Shamrocks, riding a three-game winning streak and preparing for the home stretch for the IHSAA tournament with three games, two of them at Hendricks Regional Health Stadium, including last Friday night's game against the Shamrocks. It was a cold, windy, and toward the second half, rainy night in Avon, but the Orioles struck first, and they struck often in the first quarter after taking advantage of a Westfield miscue. On the opening kickoff, the fumble recovered by the Orioles led to a 16-yard touchdown pass from Brandon Peters to Andrew Griffin. And before the first quarter was over, the Orioles had put four touchdowns on the scoreboard. But Westfield came back, scoring the next 20 unanswered points before Avon's Brian Fitzgerald scampered off on a 57-yard touchdown run in the fourth quarter to put the game away, with the Orioles winning 35-20. It would be quite a night for the young junior, as Fitzgerald had an interception return for a touchdown of 72 yards, a 1-yard touchdown run, and a 57-yard touchdown run. Orioles have now won four straight. We'll talk to the head coach of the Avon Orioles, Mark Bless, about last Friday night's game against the Shamrocks and this week's opponent, the Zionsville Eagles. This is the Mark Bless Show on Audio Sports Online. Reynolds Body Shop is a proud sponsor of Avon Football Broadcast. They are conveniently located at 4325 West Washington Street in Indianapolis, just four stoplights east of 465. Their phone is 317-243-2372, and they are open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Reynolds has been family-owned and operated for 30 years, specializing in collision repair. Reynolds Body Shop is also an insurance work specialist. Learn more about them on the web at www.reynoldsbodyshop.com.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School Football Broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County, as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
We'd like to thank Citywide Paving for their support of Avon Football and our Avon Football broadcast this year. Welcome back to the Mark Bless Show on Audio Sports Online. It's now time to talk to the head coach of the Avon Orioles, Coach Mark Bless. Avon coming off a victory Friday night, 35-20. It's the Orioles' fourth straight win. And, Coach, you start off really, really fast. And I think before anybody knows what's happening, you're up four touchdowns, and we just finished the first quarter. That kind of steamrolling effect, you got the turnover on the opening kickoff, just go straight into the end zone, and things just kind of steamrolled in that first quarter. Did you know what was happening before it got done?
Well, one of the things we did talk about during the week and the night before the game certainly was we wanted to get off to a quick start. Didn't imagine it'd be that quick of a start, but tribute to our players. The guys took it for word, and they came out and played really explosively from the start. And very pleased with the way we came out.
After the first quarter, things kind of changed. Now, granted, it was a cold, wet, and in the second half especially, a little bit of a rainy night, and I'm sure the conditions, as it always does, it affects both teams. But that first quarter kind of had the winds a little bit at your back. You were throwing the ball quite a bit in that first quarter. You flipped the field, and then was it a conscious effort? Okay, we got a stiff wind in our face. We got a four-touchdown lead. Let's try to keep it on the ground a bit.
A combination of things, probably, Brian. First of all, I think the win really had the biggest factor in our special teams play with our kickoffs And then in the, you know, certainly you're able to throw a little easier. But, you know, with Brandon Peters being a quarterback, arm strength, throwing in the wind I don't think is that big of an issue for Brandon. But in the second quarter, I thought, you know, a couple things. I think we wanted to run a little more clock, and you do that by being able to run the ball. Well, you do it passing the ball too, but you got to complete passes and make sure that, you know. I don't think we're looking to get the game over quicker, but, you know, when you're facing the win, I think it changes a few things. But the special teams play certainly was a big factor because now we're punting. When we have to punt, we are punting into a pretty good wind. And I think that made us a little more cautious, more than anything. I think our intensity level probably dropped a little bit when you get up by, you know, the kind of lead that we had. And then right before half when Westfield completed a fade route to get a score, I think that, you know, gave them a little more energy than what they started the game with.
You have that kind of, a lull in the second quarter. They get the touchdown late. The offense, to me, has always been – it's very much – we don't call it tempo like we see in a traditional spread where it's hurry, hurry, hurry. But it's definitely one that when we see Brandon start to click – you don't want to stop him because he just seems to get into that zone. Running the ball and then coming out in the second half, did you feel like maybe you lost a little bit of timing and a little bit of that clicking that goes on with the offense, especially there in the first quarter?
Yeah, probably. And I'll take the blame in the second half more than anybody because we chose to kick off both halves. Well, actually, we chose the wind the second half because, you know, we're Brian. 28-7, and in my mind, if we can, you know, pin them down and keep them in their own territory with a good, strong kickoff, good defensive effort, we get the ball back because now they're punting into the wind. We get the ball back in great field position, try to capitalize on that and get, you know, a couple more quick scores in there. And when they were faced third and long and hit the screen pass that picked up a significant gain, I think that kind of deflated that thought and that idea. And I thought Westfield did a good job of moving the ball. And then when we got the ball back, I think we tried to press it a little bit too much. But again, you know, I take blame for that because I'm the one that chose, instead of receive the opening kickoff of the second half, we chose the win instead. So, you know, that's on me 100%. But that was my thought process at that time, I guess.
Brian Fitzgerald, again, another outstanding night as far as on both sides of the ball, offense, defense, ran for a couple of touchdowns, had the big pick, and he's just been a player, as we've seen each and every week. We always talk about Brandon. We talk about Andrew Griffin, Matt Moore, but Bryant has really, as you've said in the past, you don't want to take him off defense because we can see his direct result of his play on that side and in the kick return game. Offensively, he's getting the snaps. When we talk about, I think, and I may be wrong about this, Coach, it's really seemed like in the last 5 or 10 years that, especially as colleges start looking at their recruits, we've seen this athlete tag put on many. And Bryant really fits that mold, is that wherever you put him, he's going to play well.
Yeah, and, you know, he does fit that category. You know, as mentioned, he is very valuable to our defense, and, you know, he's very explosive on our offense and special teams. So we do want to try to keep him as fresh and as healthy as possible. You know, one other thing we like to do, we like to have more than just one running back to be able to perform in a game, and I think we've got three pretty legitimate running backs that we're able to rotate in with Darian Love and Corey DePriest, along with Fitz, and it really gives us a good change up in our run game. But, you know, we want to make sure that we stay as healthy as we can coming in as we approach the tournament.
As speaking of health and coming out of that game, again, a bit of a cold, wet night didn't seem to affect you too badly as far as coming out of that game healthy.
No, I feel very good where we're at health condition-wise of our team. And, you know, I think our players play hard. I think when we practice, we've learned to practice a little bit smarter and not try to get guys banged up during the week of practice preparing for your opponent. But we still want to be able to play physical. So, you know, there's phases of our practice where we will have a little more contact than others. But I think, you know, we're trying to take the right approach, to not try to be as healthy as possible going into the tournament.
Orioles have one more road game in this IHSA regular season before wrapping it up at home. And when we come back, I'll talk to Coach Bless about the Orioles' trip to Zionsville this week. This is the Mark Bless Show on Audio Sports Online.
Avon has a rich wrestling tradition, and now Red Cobra Wrestling is proud to be a part of it. Opening last November, Red Cobra Wrestling offers training sessions run by nationally known coach Chad Red. Red Cobra Wrestling is located at 9233 East Highway 36 in Avon, across the street from Walmart and behind sidelines in the Red Brick Building. Red Cobra Wrestling offers sessions for all ages, including third grade and under and fourth grade and up. Learn more about prices, class schedules, and information at RedCobraWrestlingAcademy.com.
Avon Dental Center is a proud sponsor of Avon High School Sports Broadcast. Dr. Timothy Greer and Dr. Christopher Lefebvre have served Hendricks County families for over 20 years. Located in Avon's Beechwood Center area just east of Ivy Tech, they're open Monday through Friday, although early morning hours are available. Avon Dental Center offers high-tech dentistry that includes dental implants, orthodontics, and one-appointment crowns. At Avon Dental Center, their priority is to deliver quality care to informed patients in a comfortable and convenient setting. You can get more information at avondentalcenter.com or call for an appointment at 272-8100. Avon Dental Center.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954, with 8 convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900. Welcome back to the Mark Bless Show on Audio Sports Online. Avon will finish up the road portion of their regular season schedule this week when the Orioles travel to take on the Zionsville Eagles. And, Coach, this is a Zionsville team. We saw it at the end of last season as they started making some nice strides. The beginning of this season, they did pretty good. They were playing very good football. They have since tailed off a bit. But one of the things I think we've seen out of Zionsville, they transitioned to more of a spread offense last year. They kind of started it this year. But now they've kind of found a back in Brendan Mikkelsen that really a very good tailback and a quarterback in Trevor Lichty that seems to be able to get the ball where he needs to be, but they still have a few pieces they need on offense to be a little more consistent.
Well, you know, you watch them on film, and, you know, you can tell they're well-coached. Coach Etcheverry does a very nice job. There is a little bit of a transition going from different philosophies and moving the ball. But, you know, when you watch them, you know, the running back does run very strong. Receivers have very good speed, and the quarterback's capable of getting them the ball. So, you know, one of the things we want to make sure we're able to do, similar to last week, is try to pressure the quarterback and try to get him to hurry some throws. You know, I think our secondary play has gotten better throughout the course of the year, and we need to continue developing on that.
The Eagles are coming off of a loss to Brownsburg. And, Coach, when you sit there and you look at the score and you say, well, you got 107 points put up on the board in a night, and really kind of a not too great of a night for, you would think, for most offenses. Granted, Brownsburg put 66, but Zionsville still was able to move the ball. And as you said, you want to get that pressure. I think Zionsville on the night, they managed to get 41 points in only 377 yards. So they were able to make some strikes and get some points. You're looking for the defensive pressure. What do you want to do against their very talented tailback, Brendan Mikkelsen?
Well, you know, when you watch that game, the Brownsburg game, Zionsville, you know, there were spurts in there, and probably similar to ours, because Brownsburg jumped out to a significant lead, and then Zionsville pulled it within 7 or 8, I think. And then, you know, there was a couple crucial plays in there, and it kind of turns the course of the game. So, you know, we pay close attention to what they're doing. We got to make sure that, you know, we play a little more consistent than what we did last week and not playing our spurts, highs and lows of the game. So, you know, really the key is making sure we control the line of scrimmage on both sides of the ball and try to win the turnover war.
Turnovers were a big part against Westfield, and one of the things that I thought you did a really good job of is when you got the turnovers, you made the most of those opportunities to turn them into points.
Yeah, I think so, and I think it started off, you know, with Fitz with his pick six, and that kind of ignited us. And I think offensively we did a very good job of taking care of the ball. And those are points of emphasis that we're trying to make. We just now got back to even on the turnover ratio. We started the season off on the plus side and or the negative side, and you never want to be on that side. So hopefully we can build on the turnover battle. I thought defensively last week coming up with some pretty big interceptions besides Bryant's. Brody Goode had one. Lance Meyer had one. We had a couple fumble recoveries. And, you know, certainly can make a big difference in the game and turn it around. So we got to make sure that we try to finish on the plus side on the turnover ratio.
One thought about last week's game, we noticed that late in that game, for the past few games, we've had Matt Moore and Brian Fitzgerald back on punt return. But I noticed on, like, the last punt, you got Luke Sjajotovic in there to return punts.
Well, Luke's a pretty shifty player, and he's you know, very capable of fielding punts, and we just want to make sure we get him some reps. We work on it throughout the week of practice, and we just want to make sure that, you know, he's getting some varsity reps just in case he's ready to go or if we need him in there. He'll be a very good player for us down the road.
All right, the Orioles, they will be taking on the Zionsville Eagles. That is this Friday. Pre-game show will begin at 6:30 here on Audio Sports Online, and then the kickoff between the Orioles and the Eagles is at 7 o'clock. Coach, good luck this week.
Very good. Thank you, Brian.
You've been listening to the Mark Blass Show on Audio Sports Online. Tonight's show has been brought to you by Reynolds Body Shop, McNamara Florist, Red Cobra Wrestling, Citywide Paving, Changes Home Care, and Avon Dental Care. Tune in next week when we once again talk to the head coach of the Avon Orioles, Coach Mark Blass. The Mark Blass Show is an AudioSportsOnline.com production.
Reynolds Body Shop is a proud sponsor of Avon Football Broadcast. They are conveniently located at 4325 West Washington Street in Indianapolis, just four stoplights east of 465. Their phone is 317-243-2372, and they are open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Reynolds has been family-owned and operated for 30 years, specializing in collision repair. Reynolds Body Shop is also an insurance work specialist. Learn more about them on the web at www.reynoldsbodyshop.com.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
It's time for Avon Oriole football on ASO. Tonight's game is brought to you by Reynolds Body Shop, McNamara Florist, Avon Dental Center, Changes Home Care, Red Cobra Wrestling, and Citywide Paving. Avon Oriole football on Audio Sports Online is produced tonight by ASO. How about that? How's that work out for you? I'm Brian Scott as we get ready for game number 7 of the IHSAA regular season, and as you might say, it's been kind of a long season, but it's coming to an end very, very quickly. One final game before we head into sectionals. That'll occur next week, and it'll be back at Hendricks Regional Health Stadium. Tonight, we're at St. Vincent Health Stadium, at Zionsville High School, the home of the Eagles, as the Avon Orioles come into tonight's game ranked number 7 in Class 6A, and they're going to take on the 14th ranked Zionsville Eagles of Class 5A here on Audio Sports Online. Avon coming off of a win last week. They defeated Westfield, and we're going to take a minute and have our national anthem. Very fine rendition of our national anthem here tonight at Zionsville High School as we get ready for football between the Avon Orioles and the Zionsville Eagles. As I mentioned, Zionsville tonight is the Orioles' opponent as the Orioles go on the road for the final time this regular season. Avon coming off of a win last week, 35-20 against Westfield on a cold, wet, and rainy night at Hendricks Regional Health Stadium. It was a game that if you watched the first quarter, you would have thought, well, this looked much like the Whiteland game earlier in the season, as Avon raced out to an early 28-0 lead and seemed to be well on their way to possibly another cruising victory. But that's not quite how the game ended up. Before long, Westfield managed to score a touchdown to end basically the first half, but the Orioles still had a 3-touchdown advantage. The wind, the rain, and the temperatures made head coach Mark Bless decide to kick the ball. He had the choice in the second half, and as you heard in the pregame show, he decided to kick the football. And before they know it, the Orioles find themselves in a football game as Westfield scores 20 unanswered points and seemingly moving down for what could have been the game-tying touchdown, up with the Orioles up by 8 in the fourth quarter. But Lance Myers with a big, big interception, and then it was Bryant Fitzgerald doing the damage with a 57-yard touchdown run to basically seal the game. And while the Orioles never trailed in the game, there were some anxious moments, especially in that second half. For the Zionsville Eagles, they played last week at Brownsburg, and it wasn't a very good game for the Eagles. They lost their third straight game as they fell to Brownsburg 66-41, as the Brownsburg offense pretty much had their way with the Zionsville defense. And while the Eagles were able to put 41 points on the board, they could do nothing to stop the juggernaut that was the Bulldogs offense last week. It's Toksak and Rabade. He rushed for 243 yards. Hunter Johnson had 5 touchdown passes and 233 yards through the air, while the Eagles could only manage 104 yards through the air and didn't fare that much better on the ground. They eventually managed to put up about 230 to 250 yards on the ground, but it's simply they couldn't get they couldn't stop the Bulldogs long enough to make that game even close. So I bring in the Indiana Hall of Famer and welcome back from a very nice week up in your old stomping grounds. And you got to see at least the film of last week's game as far as the Avon Orioles are concerned. And as we kind of talked before the game, a little bit two different halves.
It was. And, you know, that's the thing as a head coach you're always working toward, is to get your team to play hard and consistent football for four quarters. And, you know, I think for the most part, Avon has done that. There's been a few mental glitches, but, you know, you see that at the NFL level. You know, that's been a complaint with the Colts most of the season. You see that with the college teams, a little bit with your school, Ohio State, and, you know, a couple of the other big-time programs. So, you know, it's not just something that high school kids have to worry about, but it is something as a head coach that you certainly try to guard against. And, you know, when Avon came out to that outstanding first quarter again last week, as much as you try to stay focused and, you know, and get after it and have that steady, consistent play, it is tough to keep up that same level of concentration when you're up that early, you know, by four touchdowns. But I do think they're showing a lot of maturity. Avon is a senior-dominated team, and, you know, when things got close and maybe a little bit tense for the fans and the broadcasters in the second half, those seniors did show, a little moxie and did hang in there. And Lance Meyer, who's been a kind of a steady Eddie for Avon in the secondary the entire year, you know, makes a big play. And, you know, and Fitzgerald, who's been a big play player on both sides of the football, came through with the big play to kind of clinch things. So, you know, it's a win. You chalk it up. We've had a couple of close games go the other way. And, you know, this point in the season, you're looking to do two things. You're looking to play better each week than you did the week before. And quite honestly, when you're getting this close to the tournament, you're looking to stay healthy. And it's my understanding that, you know, Avon came out of the game health-wise in pretty good shape. So we've got, you know, the game tonight, the game next week. The draw is on Sunday. And, you know, coaches will tell you all the time that they're not looking ahead, but we always lied because we always were. And, you know, you're playing the what-if game about, you know, what do we need to do today and what do we need to do to win this game tonight. But, you know, anybody that tells you that they're not peaking a little bit down the road is lying. You know, we've got a tough sectional. We want to finish up the season here in good shape, and we want to make sure we move into the tournament playing our best football and trying to be as healthy as we can.
The Zionsville Eagles are under the second year for head coach Pat Echeverria. A totally new offense as compared to what Coach Larry McWhorter ran here for many years. They run the spread offense. They're running a 3-4 defense. And while the offenses kind of come along the path this year, they are scoring some points. It's been the defense that has really been the problem for Zionsville this year. They have given up the most points in Hoosier Crossroads Conference action, and they're going to be facing a team that has given up the fewest points, not only in conference play, but of all Hoosier Crossroads Conference teams in the Avon Orioles, as the Orioles defense has been very, very strong all season long. They are led by senior quarterback Trevor Lichty, a 6'3", 170-pound senior quarterback. He will be running pretty much a pistol set. You'll see a lot of option with him, and you will also see a very, very talented tailback in Brendan Mickelsel. He is probably only second in the conference to Brownsburg's talented tailback Toksak and Rabati in rushing yardage. He is averaging about 163 yards a game coming into tonight's game. So a very talented tailback, a pretty good quarterback. It's just a matter of, Coach, what can they do to maybe get the ball spread around? And as good as that Avon defense has been, or the Avon offense has been all year, the defense has just been outstanding. And what can Zionsville do against a very tough Avon defense?
Well, you know, I mean, I don't want to eat my words here later, but if Zionsville has to be in a track meet with the Avon offense tonight, it's going to be a tough night. We saw 3-4 weeks ago, I think Brownsburg came in a pretty similar situation. Their offense has, you know, just been lighting it up and putting points up against everybody. And, you know, their defense has struggled, although it looks like they're, you know, shoring things up there a little bit. But, you know, they hung with us for a little bit, and then our defense kind of kicked in, and we shut Brownsburg down in the second half. So, you know, Zionsville's going to have to come out here and open things up and try to keep up as best they can. And I think, you know, the best thing that they can hope for is that maybe Avon's not on their game, maybe makes a few mistakes, turns the ball over, has a few penalties, because if Avon's clicking on all cylinders, you know, it could be a long night.
And this does seem to be the type of game that this Brandon Peters-led Avon offense. It's one of these games that you got them licking their chops. I'm sure Brandon is definitely looking over that secondary. And as well as Andrew Griffin, Matt Moore, we have seen we've seen this Avon offense really come along, but the trio now of running backs, Brian Fitzgerald, Darian Love, and Corey DePriest. Now you're getting three different looks at three different tailbacks, each with their own dynamic abilities. Darian Moore, the punishing straight ahead. Bryant really has that explosiveness and just making that play. And then Corey, once he can get, if he can get around the outside, you're not going to stop him.
Well, I think just the fact that you're talking about three quality backs says something about the Avon offense. And obviously Brandon Peters is, you know, is a focal point, but You know, you've got Andrew Griffin. If there's a better wide receiver in the state, I haven't seen him, and I've made the statement all year about Matt Moore that I think he's as good a tight end as I've seen at the high school level, you know, in my over 40 years of coaching. So you've got those two quality guys. The offensive line has been solid all year. You know, the two freshmen that maybe I worried about. I don't know about any other people earlier in the year playing against, you know, 6A opponents. Those two freshmen now have played, you know, they're in their seventh varsity game. They're not rookies anymore, and, you know, and they're playing very solid. And I think Avon's offense, Eric Moore does a nice job kind of mixing things up and diversifying. And, you know, they can throw it short, throw it long, run a little option. They started the game a couple of weeks ago with Brandon Peters running, you know, running a quarterback draw at Fisher. So, you know, they've got a lot of weapons. They can mix things up, and they present a lot of problems. And you're right. I've said all year, I think Avon's front seven plays as tough as anybody I've seen. If I had a question mark early, it was in the secondary. But their front seven puts so much pressure on the quarterback that, you know, that the secondary has survived, and I think gotten better also as the season's gone on. So defensively, they're solid. If there's been a bugaboo for Avon this year, I think primarily it's been, you know, maybe a little bit with the turnovers. And, you know, we've talked a little bit with some penalties and some mistakes in the kicking game, and I know that's the thing that they work every week to try to improve on.
Let's give you the particulars for tonight's game. I mentioned the Orioles are ranked 7th in Class 6A. That's where they were last week. They have a record of 5-2, 3-1 in the Hoosier Crossroads Conference. Head coach is Mark Bless, 45-20 in his 6th year at the helm of the Orioles, 194-87 in his 26th year overall. The Zionsville Eagles, the home team, they're 3-4 this year, 0-4 in Hoosier Crossroads Conference action, but they are ranked 14th in Class 5A. The head coach is Pat Echeverria. He is 6-11 in his second year at the helm of the Eagles and 29-25 in his fifth year overall. The Orioles have won their last four contests. The Eagles have lost their last three. And as I mentioned, Zionsville still looking for that first Hoosier Crossroads Conference win. It is senior night here at Zionsville. The Eagles are in the home green, and if we are going to apologize right off the bat, their numbers are very, very difficult to read. They are basically dark numbers with just white outlines. And from the press box, very difficult to read. Of course, the Orioles, white jerseys, white pants, the black numbers with yellow trim and the black helmets. It is very similar tonight to last Friday, maybe a little bit warmer temperature, about 60 degrees. The wind blowing at, I'd say, about 15 miles per hour, and it goes from left to right as you look at it. But no chance of rain tonight, so a very, very nice fall evening here in central Indiana for week number 8 of the Indiana high school football season. Sectional pairings will be announced on Sunday, and final game of the regular season, that is next week. So we're ready for some football here from St. Vincent Health Stadium at Zionsville High School, as it will be Sam Perino, who has done an absolutely fine job of kicking this year. He had a bit of a shaky start in his first two games, but his punting average, his kickoffs, he's gotten a couple of field goals. He has done a very, very fine job kicking for the Orioles this season. Back deep will be John Ramsey Jr. and Brock Bishop for the Eagles. We're ready for football. We hope you enjoy tonight's game on Audio Sports Online. Perino puts a foot into it. He will kick it. It will go deep. And the first play of the game will be from the 20-yard line for the Eagles, as Perino, with a wind to his back, sends it through the end zone.
Almost out of the end zone.
And almost out of the end zone. And it will be Trevor Lichty and the Zionsville offense that will come to take the first snaps of the football game. Again, Lichty, a 6'3", 170-pound senior. And we expect to see a lot of pistol spread looks from Zionsville in this football game. They will run a lot of 3 and 4 wides, and that's exactly how they will start this game, with 4 wides and Brendan Mickelson, the tailback, to the right of Lichty. As he looks over 3 down front, they send a man in motion. And the first play from scrimmage is Brendan Mickelson right up the middle, and Mickelson will get about 3 yards, and that's how the Eagles start this game. First play is a 3-yard run for Mickelson. Let's give you the Eagles offense. Across the offensive line, Josh Janock, Chase Fisher, Carter Dunshee, Teddy Lipinski, and Andrew Sabot. The wideouts, Jay Edwards, Sam Edgel, John Ramsey Jr., the H-back, Eddie Mattingly. The running back is Brendan Mickelson, and the quarterback is Trevor Lichty. They will send a man in motion, but the give is to Mickelson. He'll look for some room out the corner. He'll find Matt Thompson. And Mixel will get maybe a couple of yards, and he will take it up to the 28. Mixel will be short, and it'll be third and short.
Yeah, I mean, the first couple of plays here, they're trying to establish the run, really 4 yards a clip, not bad. Big down here. But, you know, if Zionsville is able to run the football tonight, then, you know, they could make it interesting.
So we'll bring a third down and two, three wideouts. He'll have the H-back Mattingly, but it gives to Mike. So he will look for some room, find it around the right side, and he will plunge ahead for 2.5 yards, but it will be enough for an Eagle first down.
Yeah, right now, the first three plays, they've done a nice job. They've blocked the Avon front. You know, I've said a lot of glowing things about the entire year, but right now Zionsville, at least on the first three plays, is blocking the Avon front pretty well, and they've, you know, run three plays and picked up the first down.
So first and 10 Avon, or for Zionsville, as they give it to Mikasol, and this time he just runs right into the front defensive line of the Orioles and will get very little, maybe a half yard at best, make it second and long.
Yeah, it's, you know, difficult early in the game to tell if they're trying to establish the run or, you know, I'm looking at the flag here a little bit and we watch a kickoff nearly go out of the end zone. You know, we're sitting in this nice warm press box, so it's, you know, pretty difficult to tell just how strong that wind is blowing out on the field.
Second down along nine, opening drive of the football game as the Eagles send a man in motion. No play action pass. Lichty will throw it down the field. He had two receivers, and they were covered by one Oriole, and they misfire on the pass. It goes incomplete.
Yeah, I think Scott Campbell over there playing the corner on the left side stayed back, ran with him pretty well. You know, I've mentioned my philosophy here most of the year. I think it's good for any offense to try to go deep early in the game just to kind of loosen things up. And, you know, you hope to hit it, but you also hope just to let them know you have that in your offense.
So third and long, they will send it out to the near side. This is, I believe, Ramsey. He makes a move, gets past an Oriole defender. They were trying to set it up to cut to the inside, but he cut it back outside. And John Ramsey will have the first down out beyond the 45 to about the 46-yard line.
Yeah, that's one of those plays that, you know, now maybe they'll understand that outside guy's got to keep contained. And, you know, he thought he had to go inside to make the tackle. And when he went inside, he gave up the outside and gave up the first down.
So another first down for the Eagles, takes it out to the Zionsville 46-yard line. Opening drive of the first half, and it's already 2 minutes in. As they will bring one man in motion, that's Mattingly. Here is Lichty. He'll get it out to Michelson. Michelson turns the corner. He's down the sideline. One man to beat. That's Andrew Griffin. He gets inside Griffin. And finally coming down and making the play from behind. See who that is that chased him down. I believe it was Lance Meyer.
It'll be a hold or illegal.
But there is a penalty flag back at the Oriole 22-yard line as Michelson got down that far sideline. He cut inside Griffin. Griffin couldn't make the tackle. Meyer brought him down, but a hold's going to bring this one back.
Well designed play. I like that play. He, you know, he rolled out like he was going to run and actually put that outside linebacker in a bind. I mean, if he dropped to stay with the receiver in the flat, then the quarterback, I'm sure, would have continued to run and taken a corner and run just a little quarterback sweep. But, you know, when the outside linebacker came up, it freed up the man in the flat. It was just really a little, about a 5-6 yard pitch and catch. And, you know, once he made the catch, it was open field. So, you know, it's nice for Avon that we got the hold, but a very, very nicely well-designed play by Zionsville.
The penalty will make it instead of first and goal inside the 10. It'll move it back, but it's deep in Oriole territory at the 32-yard line. And the Zionsville Eagles will send a man in motion on first and 10. They'll swing it out to the flat. They got their man at the 30. Another hold penalty. And brought down is Eddie Mattingly from the H-back. But, again, another penalty flag. This one back at the 31-yard line. And another hold will push the Eagles backwards.
Yeah, that one was obvious enough that, you know, we could see that even up here in the booth. When you see that jersey get dragged as much as it was on, and he really had position. I mean, if he'd just stayed there, he would have had a block just by his position on the field. But, again, Avon's gotten a break because right now Zionsville has done a nice job mixing things up. And, you know, other than the penalties, they're moving the football here pretty freely.
Well, the Eagles, who might have had the ball almost inside the 10-yard line, now find themselves back at the Oriole 41-yard line. Well, they'll have first down and about 17 to go at the Oriole 41-yard line as the officials. And they are going to send Levi Hawk off. I don't know if his helmet had come off or... and they are sending him off. So
Garrett Blunk.
Griffin Blunk is going to come
Griffin
in.
Griffin Blunk.
So Levi might have lost his helmet. He had to come out for a play, and now they'll wind the clock as Lichty will give it to Mikasel. Mikasel will squeeze through. Actually, that was Eddie Mattingly. Mattingly came coming over. He was in an H-back, slipped in beside Lichty, took the handoff, and he'll gain about 4 yards down to about the 35-yard line. It'll be second and 13.
Yeah, I'm impressed and quite honestly a little bit surprised right now that Zionsville's offensive line is just really blocking extremely well up front against the Avon defense.
Three wide outs to the far side. They will bring one man in motion. Lichty back to pass. Pressure comes. He will launch it going over the far side, and he has his man, and he will go out of bounds. He eluded the defender but couldn't stay in bounds over on that far sideline. Jay Edwards.
Great adjustment to make the catch by the receiver. I mean, a good throw under the circumstances, especially throwing into the wind, but a great adjustment by the receiver. And again, the offensive line did a great job. He really wasn't pressured. He had plenty of time to throw, and that ball was thrown pretty far down the field. That was not a short throw.
Scott Campbell managed to push him out, but it'll be first and goal from about the six. There's Mikasel. He will look for some room around the left side. Won't find a lot as Levi Hawk comes back in from his middle linebacking position. We haven't given you the Oriole defense. Across the defensive front, Timmy Osho, C.J. Hunt, A.J. Elcock. The linebackers are Brody Goode, Levi Hawk, and Zach Batustic. Lance Meyer and Scott Campbell are the corners, and the safeties are Andrew Griffin, Brian Fitzgerald, and Matt Thompson. It'll be second down and goal from the Oriole 5-yard line, 8:22, and a long drive to begin the game. They go the jet sweep. They'll try to get the corner, and he did not get it.
No, but he's down to the 1-yard line.
He's down to the one. Is Brian Fitzgerald made the tackle on Eddie Mattingly, and it'll be third and goal. And with the ball just about the 1-yard line, maybe just outside it.
The head coach of me is coming back here a little bit, too. I'm watching that. Zionsville's dressed in green, and the three guys that they have down there signaling in the players are dressed in bright red to make it easier to see them on the sidelines. But they're in a no-huddle, hurry-up, signaling in offense.
Well, bring a man in motion. The give is to Mikasel. He'll look for some room around the right side, and no signal, and he's short. So Mikasel did not get in as the Orioles stop him under a crush. I believe Levi Hawk might have been able to bring him down right before he got to the goal line, but that'll bring up fourth and goal.
I don't know how the official on that far side can see that. He's at least 25 yards away, but he definitely made the signal that he did not get in.
No questions here. They'll go for it on fourth and goal from the one. Lichty will now bring Mikasel to his left. He gives to Mikasel. He's going to be blown up in the backfield. It's coming across with Zach Batustek.
Well, for as well as they blocked the entire drive, you had to know that Avon was bringing pressure. And Zach made a great blitz, just, you know, came right up the middle and came clean. I mean, nobody attempted to block him. Nobody got anything on him at all. And, you know, he broke clean. So they put together a great drive, and unfortunately for Zionsville, came away empty.
So Brandon Peters and the offense come on after the defense keeps the Eagles out of the end zone as Brandon Peters, who has thrown for over 1,720 yards, has first and 10 from his 5. He slings it out, almost interception. He was looking for Matt Moore, but that one might have led him just a little bit too much, and coming in to possibly get his hands on what looked like it would have been an interception was Jimmy Sullivan.
Yeah, he was definitely looking for Matt. I'm not sure Matt was looking for Brandon, because looked like he might have been wanting to throw the ball to the outside. Some miscommunication, wrong route. Brandon thought he was going to do something other than what he did, because, you know, there was nobody really there.
Andrew Griffin is alone wide out to the far side. Harrison Weber and Jordan Peterson to the near side. Second and 10, and this play will not get started as whistles blow the play dead. Brandon Peters comes into this game throwing for over 1,723 yards on the season. He is thrown for 23 touchdowns. He has rushed for a pair this year. Only 2 interceptions all season long and a 63% completion ratio.
Yeah, those stats are good, but here's, you know, we talked earlier, here's the thing that kills you. I mean, it's a first play of the game, we have a miscommunication. Second play of the game, we've got a penalty. We're already on the 2-yard line, you know, and now we're back here second and 12 deep in our own territory.
Darian Love is the tailback to the left of Peters as the play clock winds down, and Peters will get the play off. He will take it right up the middle. He found a hole, dives forward, and he will pick up about 6-7 yards. Wanted to throw the ball, but saw an opening and took it and gained a little bit of breathing room to make it third down and about 7.
Well, I think, again, a very good decision. It was one of those cloudy reads. You know, he might have been open. He might not have been. Brandon's smart enough to know you're down inside the 5-yard line. You don't want to, you know, that's a throw you might make in midfield, but when you're down this far, you just don't take the chance. He took the safe route and picked up 5 yards.
Weber and Griffin to the near side. Jordan Peterson to the far side on 3rd and 7. Brandon back to pass. Good protection. Now he'll take it off and run. He'll have, and he will get very close to the first down. He looked a little hesitant. I thought he was just going to take it straight up, but then looked like he was going to try to make some room to his left, and that cost him as he'll be short of the first down. It'll be 4th and 2, and on comes Sam Perino in the punting unit.
Yeah, I mean, the sparring on the first series from both teams right now, you've got to give it to Zionsville, even though the score is still nothing to nothing. Zionsville put together 3-4 first downs and marched it down the field. Avon did make the big play on 4th down and stop them, but, you know, failed to come up with the first down, and they've got to turn the ball back over to Zionsville.
Perino will punt from his end zone. High snap, but he gets it away, and a beautiful punt. That'll chase him back to the 40-yard line, making a move to the 45, and then pulled over was Nolan Ellsbury, but as we said,
Matt Thompson.
Matt Thompson with the hit, but Sam Perino, his punting since really the Ben Davis game after that has been excellent. He booms and manages to pin the Eagles at least back into their own territory after punting from his own end zone. So Zionsville will start this drive 1st and 10 from just outside their own 45-yard line. No score with 6:03 left to play in the opening quarter. Alongside the Indiana Football Hall of Famer Dave Shelbourne, I'm Brian Scott. Zionsville with a very impressive offensive drive to begin the contest, but the Orioles kept them out of the end zone on a nice play by Zach Batustic, and now Zionsville back out for their second drive. They'll send Mattingly in motion. Lichty will not get this play off as it'll be blown dead from the far sideline with a penalty. And a false start will be called against Zionsville. Lichty looked like he was wanting to hit Mattingly, just kind of out there on the right side, but the play was blown dead, and they'll bring up 1st and 15.
Yeah, the other thing to keep in mind is, you know, right now Zionsville is on offense into the wind, but they, you know, they've been moving the football, and Avon's only run 3 plays with the wind, but haven't had a chance to take advantage of it.
So 1st and 15 for Lichty and the Eagles. And the give is a play-action pass. They get the pass to 40 to the 45-yard line, to the 50. That is Mattingly as he's brought down. Lance Meyer along with Timmy Osho.
Andrew Griffin.
And Andrew Griffin, but it's a pickup of about 10, almost 11 yards into Oriole territory. They'll spot the nose of the football just shy of the Oriole 49-yard line, 2nd and 4.
Yeah, nice little play-action pass. Just faked a little inside zone, drew the outside linebacker up, left an open seam, little pitch and catch, and 10-yard gain.
They'll stack the wide receivers left and right on 2nd and 6, and now they'll bring Mattingly in motion. And it'll be a little shovel pass. They get Mattingly drawing across, but a nice play. I believe is A.J. Elcock that got the first hit along with Levi Hawk.
Yep, Levi is a middle linebacker, didn't get fooled. And, you know, that's a good play. Again, takes the rush off a little bit, keeps you from blitzing. You're just blocking down and taking advantage of a defensive end running upfield. Levi smelled it out, made a nice play.
So 3rd and 5 for the Eagles as the clock continues to move. Under 5 minutes left to go first quarter, no score. 2nd offensive series for the Eagles. Lichty, play action pass. He fires, and the pass incomplete, and maybe getting a hand in there was Matt Thompson as well. And it'll bring up 4th down for the Eagles.
Looks like they're going for it.
And the Eagles will go for it with a football at the midfield stripe, basically, with it just across the midfield stripe. So 4th and a long 4, almost 5 yards for Lichty and the Eagles. 3 wides to the top of the formation, 1 to the near side. As Lichty waits, and he will back up. Pressure comes, and he's sacked. A.J. Elcock comes through, and he hits Lichty for the big sack. And for big A.J., That was another one of his big, big sacks. A.J. now sixth, or excuse me, for the season, A.J. has had a grand total now of 9 sacks with that sack there, and it gives the Orioles good field position at the Eagle 44-yard line.
Yeah, Avon has been a little bit. They've made 2 huge fourth down plays, and, you know, that's usually the difference in a game.
So the gives to Brian Fitzgerald, and Fitzgerald's going to be tripped up on a nice play, shooting across and making the tackle. Is Andrew Sebo as he makes the tackle. And a nice play that's going to be a loss of about a half yard on the play and make it second down and a long 10. Ball just inside the Eagle 45-yard line. Orioles will send Weber and Peterson to the near side, Griffin to the far side on this second and 10. Brandon looking over the defense. Takes the snap, hands the ball off. Here's Fitzgerald. Now he gets the corner, and he barrels over a couple of Eagles and takes it down inside the 35 to about the 32-yard line, and he'll move the chains to give the Orioles their first down of the contest.
Yeah, nice job of blocking on that left side of the offensive line for Avon. They caved it in. Looked like it was designed to hit inside because they blocked so well. He just kicked it to the outside. Once it got to the outside, it was, a lot of open ground. He ran for the first down.
First and 10 for the Orioles at the 33-yard line of Zionsville. Fitzgerald will stay in the game to the right of Peters. 3 wide outs, 2 to the near side for Avon, looking over that 3-man front for Zionsville. Brandon will give it to Fitzgerald. He will barrel straight ahead, and Fitzgerald will pick up about 4, maybe 5 yards as he just goes over the left side, looking over at Andrew Reed, who's getting the start at left guard today.
Yeah, it's a numbers game. I mean, right now Zionsville, and I watched a film last week, tried to do it last week too. They're trying to survive with 3 linemen, you know. And Avon's got the 5 offensive linemen, so numbers alone tell you that you need to run the football, and that's what Avon's attempting to do.
Second, they'll credit him for about 3, maybe 4 yards, about 6. And play action, Peters fires, has Jordan Peterson right in and out of his hands as Peterson could not hang on to that. That'll bring up 3rd down and about 7.
Yeah, I mean, that was a good play, well-designed play. You know, should have been a little bit better than it ended up. But, again, Avon's behind schedule here again. They're 3rd and 7 when you'd like to be 3rd and 1, 3rd and 2, 3rd and 7. Almost, you know, for sure dictates the throw. You know, it also allows Zionsville to set their defense a little bit differently than 3rd and 2.
4 wide receivers, and on the delay, they'll give it to Fitzgerald. He'll take it up the middle, dive forward. He'll be very, very close on the delayed handoff. Might be a half yard shy.
Yeah, he'll certainly be close enough that they're going to go for it.
And no second thought here. 4th and 1, they'll spot the ball at the 24-yard line. They need to get to the 23. So a big 4th down now for the Orioles with the clock moving, 2:32 in a scoreless first quarter here from Zionsville. And this time Brandon Peters is going to bend under center. And he will hand the ball off, a little stutter stepped, and Fitzgerald
it's going to be close.
Is going to be very close. We'll see where they spot it. Where the marker is on the side, he may be about a football length short. And the officials will look, and they will take a timeout to measure this one. But where the near side official marked the ball, and but where the ball is actually marked, this could be interesting. So we'll wait and see what happens when they bring the chains out and stretch them across. It'll either be 1st and 10 for the Orioles at the Eagle 23, or the Eagles have held on 4th down. And the Eagles didn't even have to wait for the full extension. They saw it was going to be short, and both teams have now held on 4th down as the Eagles hold the Avon Orioles on 4th and 1, and the Orioles will turn it over on downs.
Yeah, not quite what we expected out here for the first quarter. Zionsville's came in here all fired up. They're playing with a little emotion and doing some good things. And and Avon's done it from time to time throughout the year. They just look a little bit out of sync right now, and they've got the win at their back here for another 2 minutes. And you know, if Zionsville keeps the ball here for a little bit, that means Avon's going to be operating into the wind in the second quarter.
So Lechte and the offense back on the field. They've had moments where they've looked good, but they've been stymied on fourth downs. And they will go play action. The ball pass is complete. Matt Thompson, using that wrestling ability, but threw him forward.
For a first down.
As Eddie Mattingly.
Yeah, nice catch, nice throw. I mean, there was, you know, Matt had him pretty well covered. There wasn't a whole lot of an opening in there, but he put the ball exactly where he needed to put it, and his momentum carried him for the first down.
So he'll take it up to the 37-yard line, first and 10, as the clock continues to move in a scoreless first quarter here at Zionsville. Here's Michael. He will go forward, and he will maybe pick up a yard, maybe two at best, before he is brought down from behind. I believe Timmy Osho was among those that got a hold of him, and it's a gain of maybe a yard and a half for Micasol to bring up second down and a long eight for the Eagles.
Yeah, and that's the kind of first down that Avon needs. You know, that's a one-yard gain that puts them at second and nine. Your defense, again, can operate a little bit differently on second and nine than second and five.
Here's a give to Micasol. He's looking for some room around the left side. He will get a few yards. Well, there's Timmy Osho once again, and Timmy's a player that has been in for Gunnar Larson, who was injured earlier this year, and Timmy's been really playing some excellent football at that defensive end position. He makes another play there.
Yeah, for most of the year, I think Avon's front three, whoever it's been, have played very, very well. They're very aggressive off the football. They disrupt things. They get penetration. They allow the linebackers to run free and make tackles.
Third and seven for the Eagles as the clock moves down to a minute left in this scoreless first quarter. Lechte back to pass. He'll fire. Has a man incomplete. Coming in to break it up, I believe, with Scott Campbell over there on the far side as the pass a little low, but Campbell breaks it up. He was looking for Jay Edwards over there on that far side, and this time the Eagles will punt the ball for the first time as they send Ryan Stein back to kick this ball away. It will be Matt Moore and Brian Fitzgerald back deep for the Orioles at around their own, about 27-yard line. So Stein on to kick, and he muffs the kick. Stein will get it away as he almost had this one blocked, and the Orioles are going to get great field position. Scott Campbell, who on several occasions now in that has been rushing the punter, he has gotten his hands tipped one game, and he came very close that time as Stein mishandled the snap. And the Orioles have it first and 10 from the Eagle 46-yard line.
Yeah, and they've got 46 seconds left with the wind, so don't be surprised here to see Avon go deep a couple of times while they have the wind advantage.
Weber and Peterson to the near side, Griffin to the far side on first and 10 for Avon. Scoreless first quarter as Peters fires it out. This time Jordan Peterson, he hangs on, he dives forward. He'll take it inside the 40 to the 41-yard line, pick up a 7 on first and 10.
Nice little safe play. Zionsville's playing cover two, which means their safeties are playing back on the hash marks. That's just a little 5-6 yard hitch. There's no linebacker underneath. Nice safe throw on first down. They're basically willing to give it up, and Avon was smart enough to take it.
13 seconds on the game clock. The Orioles would not have to snap it, but they will, and it's a play action down the middle looking for Harrison Weber, who got a hand on it but couldn't bring it down as he was running down the seam. He was bracketed by a pair of Eagles but did manage to get a hand on the football, but that'll bring up third down in about three.
Yeah, a little play action trying to draw the linebackers up, which they did, but their secondary people stayed back, played it pretty well, would have taken a perfect throw. He threw the ball in there pretty well but just really couldn't quite hook up for the completion.
So they'll send Weber, Peterson, and Moore to the left. Griffin to the right. Darian Love is a tailback to the right of Brandon Peters. 5.4 seconds left to go in a scoreless first quarter. Long count. Peters fires. He has Matt Moore right down the seam. Moore will have the completion on a nice catch and back it inside the 30. And that will stop the clock momentarily as they move the chains. 2.4 seconds remain, so that will be the end of the first quarter as they will let the clock wind down. And we will flip ends on a very fast-moving opening quarter of play here from St. Vincent Health at Zionsville High School. We are scoreless after one. This is Avon Oriole Football on Audio Sports Online.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954, with eight convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900.
We'd like to thank Citywide Paving for their support of Avon Football and our Avon Football broadcast this year. Welcome back to Zionsville High School. We've played a surprisingly scoreless first quarter as the Orioles and the Eagles, neither one of them could put any points on the board, though the Eagles had on their opening drive the excellent opportunity. They had a fourth and goal about at the one-yard line, but Zach Batustak blew up the run to keep them out of the end zone, but neither team has been able to put any extended offense on the field since. On first and 10, here's Darian Love. He will take it right up the middle and take it to about the 25-yard line. Pick up a four on the play. That'll bring up second down and six.
Yeah, kind of to repeat what you said, if you'd have told me it was going to be tied at half or at the quarter, I would have been surprised. If you'd have told me it would be tied at 0-0, I would have been shocked. But Zionsville, you know, my hat's off to Zionsville. They came in here, at least for the first quarter, I think a little bit more ready to play mentally than Avon has. Hopefully Avon will kick it into gear here in the second quarter.
We do remind you, it is senior night here, so a big, big crowd on hand. As Brandon Peters works second down and six, fires, and he had Jordan Peterson running wide open on a little crossing over the middle at about the 20-yard line, but couldn't quite hook up with him. It would have been an easy first down. Instead, it'll bring up third down at about six.
Yeah, nice route. Ran three guys deep on seam routes, just kind of cleared things out. It's a good route against two deep. If you're running three down and they're only two deep, one of them should come open, but Zionsville dropped back, picked up the three deep guys, but left Jordan wide open coming across. And unfortunately, Brandon just overthrew him by a little bit, even though he was wide open.
Griffin to the near side, two wideouts to the far side on this third down and about six. Darian Love, he has the ball. He will bury his shoulder and take it down to about the 20, which is going to make it another very interesting call for Coach Mark Bless in the offense. It's going to be, again, fourth and maybe less than a yard to go, and they'll just leave the offense on the field once again.
Well, you know, I think part of this is just the fact that we feel that we are better than they are up front, you know, and I think that's what they thought the first time. But, you know, depending upon the game situation, you know, you might be trying to kick a field goal here. The one may be a factor, and it really just might be the fact that they think Avon thinks they're strong enough that they can pick up a yard.
On fourth and about a yard, they will run Brandon mainly out of the pistol, but they'll give it to Darian Love, and Darian Love will pick up the first down, it looks like.
On a second effort, because I'll tell you, they stopped the first.
And, well, once again, now this spot looks a little short. I thought, like you did, that on second effort he might have gotten it. They're going to measure once again. And where that football is marked, that's going to be a rather close call.
Well, they stopped the initial charge, and I thought initially that it was going to be short, but then he kind of rolled out of there and made the dive, and I thought clearly got the first down. But with this spot, we're going to have to wait for the measurement.
So for the second time in as many drives, the chains come out, and we'll see if Avon was stopped on fourth and short. They'll move the chains, and once again, the Eagles' defense holds. So back-to-back drives, the Orioles go for it on fourth and less maybe a yard or less, and both times the Eagles defense comes up with the stop, and the Orioles will turn it over on downs at the Zionsville. They'll spot the ball just inside the Eagle 20-yard line.
Well, I guess this is why you play the game. I mean, we were talking in pregame. I told you I watched the film, and I just didn't really think that Zionsville's lines either way were all that strong. But, boy, they're sure going toe-to-toe with Avon out here in the first 12 minutes of the game.
10 minutes, 39 seconds remain in this first half of a scoreless game. Alongside Dave Shelbourne, I'm Brian Scott. Lichty in the offense, back out onto the field for Zionsville. As they'll have the ball at just inside their own 20. They give it to Mikasel. He will find some room and take it upfield to about the 29-yard line. A pickup of 9, and it'll be second down and 1. Just taking it over that left side. I believe he's going over there where Josh Janak, and Chase Fisher are. And he gets a 9-yard gain on the first play from scrimmage. Second and 1. Mikasel to the left of Lichty. Three wideouts to the top of the formation. Lichty back to pass. He fires, and the pass is tipped at the line of scrimmage. Did not see who got a hand up there. Might have been C.J. Hunt that managed to get a hand up there. No, Gunnar Larson, actually, I think, is the one that got the hand up there, as he's in there at the right defensive end.
Good to see Gunner back. He's been out a couple weeks. One of their better linemen, starter last year as a sophomore. It's good to see him back.
Third and 1. They'll give it to Mikasel, and he's going to be stood up, a second effort. And the Orioles say the ball's loose. And no signal.
It's going to be a first down for Zionsville.
Mikasel on second effort. Looks like he got the first down. Orioles, there's A.J. Elcock leading his case. No, and the officials are going to talk about this one. They'll spot it down, and they will go and talk about it, and they will mark it first down for Zionsville.
Wishful thinking on the part of Avon's defense.
So Brendan Mikasel with second effort gives the Eagles a first down just over the 30, about the 31-yard line. And the clock will wind with 9:51 left to go in the half. Here's the screen. They'll set it up. It will be blown up as coming in to make the play. Not fooled for a minute was Levi Hawk. And it's a loss of about 5 on the play all the way back to the 26-yard line.
That's one of those slow down to rush plays. It's not a bad play, even if it's not successful. At least it lets Avon know they've got that in the trick bag, and, you know, they're hoping it'll slow down the pass rush a little bit.
The Eagles will send three wideouts to the near side. Mikasel will be to the left, or now to the left of Lichty, with a wide receiver at the top of the formation on second down and about 15. They'll bring Mattingly in motion. They'll fake the sweep. Lichty will be pressured. He's running near side. Penalty flag comes in, and Lichty will be brought down on a fine play by Matt Thompson. Penalty flag way back at the 21-yard line, so yeah. Another hold. And this is going to be a killer for Zionsville because it was well in the backfield. And the Eagles, well, we'll see if they elect. Coach Bless might elect just to go ahead and take this one because it wasn't much of a gain by Lichty and to bring up third down, but they are going to march him back. So they'll pin him all the way back to the 11. It'll be second down and a half acre to go. The Eagles need to get it just beyond the 40-yard line for a first down, and they're all the way back at their own 11.
Yeah, Avon needs a spark play here. They need a turnover, a sack, a fumble, a punt return. They need something to kind of light a fire under their rear ends here a little bit. I mean, they're capable of playing better right now. They're just, you know, they're just kind of going through the motions. It's unlike, you know, the Avon team we've seen most.
Bad snap. Lichty will have to eat it, and he's going to eat it at the half-yard line.
Well, there's exactly what I was talking about. I mean, Avon had nothing to do with it, but they'll certainly take advantage of it. But here they were out on the 30-yard line, and now they're basically going to end up punting out of the shadow of their own goalpost.
The ball's going to be spotted inside the 1. The nose of the football is just beyond the goal line. On a bad snap, Trevor Lichty just went back, dove on it before it got to the end zone. Looked like the Orioles were bringing outside pressure from the linebackers.
And they'll be bringing all kinds of pressure.
And here. Looks like a jailbreak about ready to. And now Lichty will just take it himself, try to get some room, and he just barely got out of the end zone.
Yeah, they're not even going to have their normal room to punt here, so this punt's going to have to be a little bit quicker and probably more of a protection punt than a coverage punt, which should give Avon really ideal field position here to hopefully get the ball in the end zone.
So a big holding penalty, a bad snap, and now Ryan Stein will put his heels on the back of the end zone as Matt Moore and Brian Fitzgerald will stand back at the Eagle 44-yard line. Stein will get it out of there, and a nice job by the Eagles punter. Fitzgerald will take it at the 46-yard line. He'll
too much room.
And he will get around to the 35, to the 30. Nice spin move to the 25-20, and there goes Fitzgerald, and he will dive into the end zone. Touchdown. A 43-yard punt return for a touchdown by Bryant Fitzgerald. And once again, Fitzgerald provides the sparks and the fireworks, and the Orioles are on the scoreboard.
I knew when he caught that ball with that much room, it was going to be trouble. I think we might have, you know, this may be one of those when both teams watch the film tomorrow, too. I think we might have got away with a hold out there in the middle of the field. But there's that play that I said Avon needed. They needed something to kind of light a fire, and hopefully this will be the play.
Sam Perino on for the point after. Andrew Griffin holds. Good snap, good hold. The kick is up. And the kick is good. 7:27 remains in the first half, and the Avon Orioles on the scoreboard. They lead the Eagles 7-0. Back with a kick in a moment. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Avon Dental Center is a proud sponsor of Avon High School sports broadcast. Dr. Timothy Greer and Dr. Christopher LaFave have served Hendricks County families for over 20 years. Located in Avon's Beechwood Center area just east of Ivy Tech, they're open Monday through Friday, although early morning hours are available. Avon Dental Center offers high-tech dentistry that includes dental implants, orthodontics, and one-appointment crowns. At Avon Dental Center, their priority is to deliver quality care to informed patients in a comfortable and convenient setting. You can get more information at avondentalcenter.com or call for an appointment at 272-8100. Avon Dental Center.
A holding penalty, a bad snap, and a punt that Stein did a good job to get out of, but just didn't leave enough time for his coverage team to get downfield. And Brian Fitzgerald takes it 43 yards to the house to give Avon a 7-0 lead. With 7:27 remaining in this first half, as Perino kicks a high kick. It hits the wind, it hits the ground, and it's finally picked up and will be returned to about the 16-yard line. So a high kick that got knocked or just basically held up in the wind. Looked like John Ramsey finally was able to get that football as it bounced around. But by the time he picked it up, the Oriole kick coverage team had managed to get downfield and bring him down at about the 18-yard line of Zionsville.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what that big play does to both teams. Zionsville has moved the football here pretty well. They've had a chance to come out and show Avon, you know, what they're intending to do. It'll be interesting to see how Avon intends to adjust and see if Zionsville continues to attack.
So lifting the offense back out onto the field, here's Michelson, and he will bounce it outside, gets around to one Oriole, tries to turn it up. He'll run into two more, but he'll get a nice gain out to about the 26-27-yard line before Timmy Oshow and Zach Batustak bring him down, but it's a pickup of about eight.
Yeah, nice play. He got to the outside. Avon really had it well defended. They had a man out there to make the tackle. He made a miss in the open field and picked up an additional 10 yards.
Actually, they'll give him a gain of 9, so it's 2nd and 1. They'll bring Mattingly in motion. They will hand it off on the jet sweep. Mattingly, penalty flag comes in, and Mattingly would have had enough for a first down, but Zionsville now really killing themselves with penalties. They had the first down on the jet sweep, but this one's going to be brought back. So what would have been 1st and 10 for Zionsville is going to make it 2nd down and about 15 from the spot of the foul. And they'll mark it all the way back to the Zionsville 12-yard line, 13-yard line. So it will be second down and about 15 yards to go.
Yeah, I mean, your field position is poor. You just went down 7-0 on a mistake. And, you know, as well and as sharp as Zionsville looked in that first quarter, you know, now they're starting to slip a little bit. They've had a multiple penalties. They've had a couple of missed assignments. They had a bad snap. You know, they don't want this to continue.
Lichty fires, and he is looking inside. He was covered by Scott Campbell looking for John Ramsey. Threw that one way over the head of both Campbell and Ramsey. And as Coach was saying, Scott was just waiting for that to come down, but it stayed up in the air. And it goes incomplete, third and 15 for the Eagles.
Yeah, I think they wanted to run a little bubble screen out here, and Matt Thompson had it covered pretty well, so he had to go looking for a secondary receiver and found a receiver upfield and did almost throw an interception.
So third and 15 is Lichty once again. They'll set up the screen. They'll get the man, and I don't know if John Ramsey knew what hit him. What hit him was Matt Thompson, who read it all the way, and basically as soon as the ball hit Ramsey, Thompson hit Ramsey, and it'll be fourth down for the Eagles.
Yeah, well, that's a play where normally you've got a wide receiver blocking a defensive back. Matt is not your typical defensive back. They've got him playing in a strong safety position out here tonight. You got a 220-pound body out there that a wide receiver is trying to block, and that just wasn't going to happen.
So Fitzgerald and Moore trying to confuse Zionsville which side Fitzgerald is going to line up is Ryan Stein. He has it blocked. It'll be picked up. See what the Eagles can do with it. As coming in and is Scott Campbell. We talked about how close he's been. He's gotten a hand on a couple. This time a full-fledged block. Fortunately, the Eagles, I believe it was Eddie Mattingly, picked up the block and at least got a little bit of yardage out. They couldn't get the first down out of it, but instead of it being at the goal line, they'll take it out to about the 19-yard line, but it'll be first and 10
saved,
Avon.
They saved them a touchdown, but nobody blocked them. I mean, very, very nice play by Scott Campbell, but he came clean. You know, I thought one of the back three guys would pick him up or bump him a little bit, but they just stood there and watched him block the kick.
So back-to-back issues on the punting for Zionsville, and now here is Brandon Peterson. He's picked off. He was looking for Andrew Griffin, and it was picked off and cleanly read, coming away with the football. Did not see who came down with it. Coming down with the football for Zionsville was Jimmy Sullivan. Brandon was trying to hit Andrew Griffin, but Sullivan read it perfectly, came and cut in front of Andrew. And this time the Eagles defense comes up with a big play.
Yeah, I mean, huge play. They actually ran the back out of the backfield, ran a wheel route on the opposite side of the field, and Zionsville sat back and played it pretty well, which I think forced Brandon to go back to the other side, thought he had Andrew open. Obviously didn't see the underneath coverage because Zionsville came away with the big interception.
It's only Brandon's third interception of the season, but it does give the Eagles first and 10 at about their own 16-yard line as Lichty will give it to Mikasel. Mikasel will look for a room on the right side. He'll pick up 2 or 3 yards on the play, get it close to the 20-yard line. It'll bring up second and 7 as we approach the midway point of the second quarter. The Orioles lead 7-0 alongside the Indiana Football Hall of Famer Dave Shelbourne. I'm Brian Scott. Orioles score comes on a punt return for a touchdown by Brian Fitzgerald. Neither team has dented the end zone via offense yet. And here's a give to Mikasel, and that one's going to be bogged up as a whole host of Oriole defenders blew it up at the point of attack, and they stood him up for little to no gain on the play.
Yeah, the Avon front six, the three down linemen and the linebackers, look like you've stirred up a hornet's nest, because that first drive, they sat there, and I don't think they expect Zionsville to come out as aggressively as they did, but now they're playing like they're mad. So, you know, they're teeing off a little bit. The inside six for Avon are playing very well.
Third and 5 for the Eagles. 3 wideouts to the near side. Lichty back to pass. He fires. Matt Thompson gets a hand in front of the intended receiver, John Ramsey. That was Jay Edwards. He was bracketed by a couple of defenders, but Thompson still able to get a hand in there and knock it away, and it'll bring up fourth down. And the Eagles punt unit, which has had two issues on the past two punts. One was returned for a touchdown. The last one was blocked. They're back out there once again. Fitzgerald and Moore kind of stack themselves up at around the 40, so they don't give a clear view of who's going to go for it. They'll kick this ball away, and Fitzgerald will take it at the 42. To the 45, tries to make a move, and a nice tackle brings him down at the 48-yard line. And that's where the Orioles will start this fast moving first half, first and 10, from about their own 48-yard line. So we haven't had a whole lot of time to catch our breath in this football game because both teams basically turning around and punting the ball back to each other. Only the 43-yard punt return for a touchdown by Fitzgerald, the only points in the game. Brandon Peters brings the offense back out. He just gave up an interception, but the Orioles' defense shuts down the Eagles, and Peters and the offense back out onto the field. First and 10, Peters steps up. He's going long, and he's got a man. He's got a step, and he just... Harrison Weber is going to hold his head in his hands because he had a step or two on the defensive back, was probably on his way to the end zone, but the ball falls through his hands, and it brings up second and 10.
Yeah, he put that ball was thrown a little over 50 yards, put it right on the money, hit him in stride, should have walked in the end zone with the touchdown, and, you know, the receiver actually limped off the field, so we've got a backup receiver in here now as well, and in addition to second and 10.
We'll see who we can. He's on the far side of the field. Andrew Buis is expected to get some action. They find Andrew Griffin at the 45, and he'll be spun down at about the 43. It'll maybe be about a football length shy of a first down.
Looks like Chad Carmichael.
Chad Carmichael is the wide receiver on the far side of the field. So Carmichael, we haven't seen a whole lot of him on offense this season, and with Harrison Weber now off to the sideline, he will come in and he will be, they will line up Matt Moore, they'll line up Carmichael slot left, but it's Brandon Peters. It's just simply going to move the pile and get the first down to about the 41-yard line. So first and 10 for the Orioles at the Eagle 41-yard line as they get the first down. And they will move the chains and wind the clock with 4:09 remaining in this first half. Orioles up 7-0.
Well, a score here certainly wouldn't put it away, but I know a touchdown here would give Avon a little breathing room and allow Coach Bless and his staff to go in and see if they can light a fire a little bit and get their guys to come out here and just play with a little bit more intensity than what they played with in the first half.
Griffin and Carmichael to the near side. Peterson and Matt Moore is the wide out to the far side of the field. And before this play gets going, it's going to be flagged dead as Corey DePriest in a tailback for Avon. And a false start called against Avon. Will back it up 5 to just inside the Eagle 46-yard line, where we'll be first and 15. 7-0 our score. The Eagles had their best chance to score in this game on the very first drive. They had it fourth and less than a yard to go for a touchdown, but the Orioles defense came up with a big play. Zach Batustak blowing up the play for a few yard loss and keeping the Eagles out of the end zone. Since then, they haven't even sniffed much of the a chance to get into the end zone. Here's Brandon Peters. He'll fire down the middle. There's Andrew Griffin at the 20. Andrew tries to spin, and he will put the ball on the field, but they will say he is down. They will blow the play dead. They say Griffin was already down at the 18-yard line as Brandon Peters hooks up with Andrew Griffin. A big play inside the 20 to about the 18-yard line, first and 10, Avon.
Yeah, we've seen that a lot, obviously, in the last 3 years. Little play action pass, again, ran everybody deep. They've got the crosser coming all the way from the backside across the formation. If the deep receivers aren't there, then the crosser should be. He hit Andrew in stride.
Carmichael stays in. He has a slot right. Andrew Griffin one-on-one to the near side. Brandon Peters on first and 10 hands it off. This is Bryant Fitzgerald. Dodges past a couple of Eagle defenders, and Bryant with a nice run picks up about six on the play as he looks like he'll be down to about inside the 12-yard line. And a pick up six, maybe 7 yards. So we'll call it third down or second down and four.
He's a big back, but he runs like a small back. You know, he can run with power. He's shifty in the open field. I know they don't want to use him a lot on offense, but he is, he's a big player. And like I said, right now they're doing everything they can just to kind of get a spark in the offense. They need a touchdown now.
Brandon will give the ball to Fitz. Fitz will dive forward, and he'll have the first down.
Nearly had it.
Almost broke it, but he's touched down at the six. It'll be first and goal, Avon, at around the six-yard line with 2:12 remaining in the first half. Avon leads 7-0. Fitzgerald with the lone touchdown, but it came on a punt return. They'll spot the ball at the seven. First and goal, Avon, and Fitzgerald will stay in. They'll send Carmichael, Jordan Peterson, and Andrew Griffin all to the right side. Matt Moore be tight end left. Fitzgerald to the left of Brandon Peters. Brandon back to pass, and he's looking for Matt Moore in the end zone. Touchdown, Avon. Ball came out. Eagles are saying that it should be incomplete, but Moore had possession, went to the turf, and as he rolled over, he let go of the football, and it will be a touchdown, a 7-yard touchdown from Peters to Moore, and the Orioles have their first offensive touchdown of the game. They lead 13-0 pending Perino's point after.
Yeah, he's just a tough matchup. You know, when you get down here, you'll see a lot of man. He's 6'3", 220, and an outstanding athlete to put somebody on him one-on-one down here when you're just trying to get the ball inside the goal line 6 yards away. That's tough to stop. They've done this on a pretty regular basis for the last couple of years. When we get down this close, you can almost expect them to either look for Matt or Andrew Griffin on some kind of isolation type route, and that's what they did.
So Sam Perino on for the point after. High snap. Griffin gets it down. Nice job by Andrew Griffin. The kick is up, and the kick is good. A minute 55 left to go in the first half. The Orioles extend their lead to 14-0. Back with a kick after this. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Avon has a rich wrestling tradition, and now Red Cobra Wrestling is proud to be a part of it. Opening last November, Red Cobra Wrestling offers training sessions run by nationally known coach Chad Red. Red Cobra Wrestling is located at 9233 East Highway 36 in Avon, across the street from Walmart and behind sidelines in the Red Brick Building. Red Cobra Wrestling offers sessions for all ages, including third grade and under and fourth grade and up. Learn more about prices, class schedules, and information at redcobrawrestlingacademy.com.
Brandon Peters hits Matt Moore on a 7-yard touchdown pass, and the Avon Orioles extend their lead to 14-0 with a minute 55 left to go in this first half. Alongside Dave Shelbourne, I'm Brian Scott. First offensive touchdown for the Orioles tonight. They had a 43-yard punt return for a touchdown by Brian Fitzgerald, and now a touchdown pass from Brandon Peters to Matt Moore, and Sam Perino set to kick this one away. High kick, gets batted down in the wind again. This one will be fielded at the 13-yard line up to the 20. And taken down there as, I believe it was Brock Bishop, the ball carrier.
Well, Zionsville has hung in there pretty well here for nearly a half. I'm kind of looking to see, you know, how they're hanging in here. You know, they played it pretty well the first quarter. Now that Avon, however ugly it's been here in the first half, is up 14-0. I'm kind of curious to see how Zionsville is going to respond. They've still got almost 2 minutes. They've got plenty of time to try to march the ball down the field and score. If they can put something on the board here before the first half, we'll have a game. Otherwise, they may go into halftime and, you know, have to get some things adjusted to come out here in the second half.
Lichty on first and 10. He fires it off to the far side, and he'll pick up about 10 yards on first down as it is caught and shedding the, I believe it was Jay Edwards on the far side. He shed a tackle from Andrew Griffin and managed to get the first down, a pickup of 11. First and 10, and the ball will be spotted at the Eagle 34-yard line. A minute 40 and counting. Both teams with full allotment of timeouts here left in the first half. Lichty back to pass again. He will again fire left side. And again, making a move and picking up about 14 yards on the play on that far side. And it was Brock Bishop, the receiver who made the catch, second catch in a row on the exact same play, and now the Eagles are up to their own 48.
Yeah, they're not being cautious. I mean, they're definitely trying to move the ball down the field here and see if they can pick up a score before the half.
Lichty mishandles the snap, and he has to fall on it again, and it's going to be a loss of about three back to the 45-yard line. And with that, Coach Pat Echeverria will call a timeout, the first of his three. With a minute 22 left to go in the first half, Orioles lead 14-0. We'll be back after this. This is Oriole Football on ASO.
Reynolds Body Shop is a proud sponsor of Avon Football Broadcast. They are conveniently located at 4325 West Washington Street in Indianapolis, just four stoplights east of 465. Their phone is 317-243-2372, and they are open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Reynolds has been family-owned and operated for 30 years, specializing in collision repair. Reynolds Body Shop is also an insurance work specialist. Learn more about them on the web at www.reynoldsbodyshop.com.
Very, very fast-moving first half of action here from St. Vincent Health Field at Zionsville High School. And the Avon Orioles lead the Eagles 14-0 alongside Dave Shelbourne. I'm Brian Scott. Orioles got their first offensive touchdown just a few moments ago as Brandon Peters hit Matt Moore from 7 yards out. That made it 14-0, and now the Eagles seeing what they can do. With a minute 22 left, they'll send Mattingly in motion, and now once again, Eagles shooting themselves in the foot as...
No, I think that was Avon.
See what the penalty will be called.
Yeah, Avon jumped off sides.
They'll call encroachment against Avon, so they'll pick up the 5 yards and make it second down and 8 with the ball right at the midfield stripe.
I will tell you, that center's going to have a headache, though. You know, we decided to go off sides, but boy, he went hard.
So Mattingly once again in motion as Lichty, quick pass, fires left side, another penalty. They'll have Bishop on the far side. And we've seen this earlier in the season where teams seem to like to look at that left side, work on the right side of the Avon defense. Penalty flag, we'll see. There's an Eagle saying it's against Avon.
Well, they're over there talking to Zionsville, so I don't know if we've got an illegal hit or hands to the head or personal foul. Yeah, face mask.
So that's a big, big penalty against the Orioles defense, and that gives them the Eagles 15 yards.
Yeah, you don't see that very often defensively, and you almost never see it if it's not on a tackle. That was on a on a defensive lineman, and his pass rush evidently got his hand up on a face mask and, you know, yanked away.
Well, that's going to march the ball all the way down to the Oriole 26-yard line, so...
And they do have the win. So, you know, if nothing else, you know, they'll want to come away here at least with three.
So first and 10, Eagles, a minute 17 and two timeouts remaining for Zionsville. They'll bring Mattingly in motion. They'll give it to him on the jet. Now he's looking to pass the ball. He'll throw it downfield, and it's caught. Penalty flag on the play, but it's caught.
It's a touchdown anyway.
As Mattingly makes the pass, and I believe... He hit. Pass was complete to Holden Hodge. So Mattingly on the.
Oh, wow. It looks like they're calling it on Zionsville. Nope. I don't know. Let's see.
Yeah, let's see. The Eagles.
Hey, Avon signaling that way, but maybe it's just wishful thinking.
Defensive holding is called. So Mattingly.
That play shouldn't have worked. They caught him in man-to-man coverage. They were in what we call trail coverage. They were up tight playing bump and run. They were just ignoring the run. I mean, that wasn't even part of their thing. But what ended up happening is kind of like that little goal line throw back shoulder route. They ended up really underthrowing it. Whether he did it on purpose or not, I doubt it, because he was throwing on the run. The receiver saw the ball, adjusted, and came back. When he attempted to adjust and come back, the Avon defender held him. Made a great catch anyway, even with the penalty. And, you know, there's that 7 points that we knew Zionsville wanted before the end of the half.
There's Ryan Stein for the point after. Kick is up, and the kick is good. 1:10 left to go in the first half. The Eagles are on the scoreboard, but they still trail the Orioles 14-7. Back with a kick in a moment. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
Eagles pull into their bag of tricks. They run the jet sweep, but Eddie Mattingly on the sweep throws it downfield. He hits Holden Hodge in the end zone. And the Eagles now on the scoreboard, trailing the Orioles 14-7. And in a game of what could have been, so you go back to that very opening drive to begin the contest where the Orioles managed to keep the Eagles out of the end zone on fourth and goal from inside the one. This could be a different-looking game, but right now it will be Brian Fitzgerald on the kickoff, a little stutter step, and he'll take it to about the 22, 23-yard line. And Avon will have it first and 10 with all three timeouts remaining and a 7-point lead. The Orioles will have the choice to begin the second half, so we'll see what they elect to do here. Up by 7 and only 1:04 left to go in the half. So Brandon Peters in the offense comes out as Harrison Weber, who went to the sidelines for a few plays on the last couple of drives. He's back into the ball game. He lines up as a third wide to the near side. Brandon back to pass. He finds Andrew Griffin. Griffin to the 40, and they'll pick up on first and 10. They'll pick up about 17 yards as they'll stop the clock to move the chains, and the Orioles quickly up to the line of scrimmage. Ball at the 40-yard line. Once again, three wideouts, two to the near side, one to the far side. They'll wind the clock, under 57 seconds remaining. Brandon back to pass. He looks, fires right side, pass is complete. Andrew Griffin, a pickup of about 12 yards into Eagle territory, and I think they're going to spot him out at about the 48-yard line, first and 10, Avon.
Yeah, Zionsville is, you know, fighting the clock here a little bit. They're sitting back in zone. I won't say they're in prevent, but they're in a little softer coverage. They certainly don't want to get beat deep. There are some holes in that underneath coverage. Avon's taking advantage of it, but they need to get it done before the clock runs out also.
Brandon back to pass, steps up, fires downfield, has Matt Moore at the 30 to the 25-20, and out at the 15-yard line on a big, big play. Brandon Peters to Matt Moore, and the Orioles are in the red zone with 45.2 seconds remaining in the half and all three timeouts.
Nice route, drag route. They brought him back across the formation. Three-man rush gives him plenty of time. Brandon just sat back there and waited till Matt dragged. I mean, he came literally halfway across the field to find that opening. Brandon put the ball on the money. When you got a quarterback like this, you can run this, the length of the field in a minute.
Ball at the 16-yard line, first and 10. Peters back to pass. He'll set up the screen. He gives it to Darian Love. Darian Love, he takes it upfield. And Darian looks like he will have enough for a first down inside the 5, down to the 3. It'll be first and goal, Avon. Clock stopped at 37.2 seconds. They'll start the clock when they get the chain set.
Looks and like they're going to take a timeout.
Avon will take the first of their three timeouts. First and goal. The ball will be at the 2-yard line when we come back. Avon leads 14-7 and knocking on the door. This is Oriole football on ASO.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954 with 8 convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900.
Darian Love's run will take it down to the 3-yard line, and that's where the Orioles will have it. First and goal from the 3 alongside Dave Shelbourne. I'm Brian Scott. 37.2 seconds remain in the first half. Orioles lead 14-7. They watch the Eagles on a trick play get it into the end zone for their first score. But they get the ball back, and they move down the field quickly on some nice throws, taking what the coverage will give them, and now they are in striking distance. They have used the first of their 3 timeouts, and now here are the Eagles running out there after they see how the Orioles line up, and the Eagles will take the second of their 3 timeouts after they got a look at what the Orioles set up offensively.
Well, you know, we're going to say the same things about Avon here that a lot of the media have been saying about the Colts. I mean, they've been stagnant the entire night. Now that we're fighting the clock, they're in a hurry-up offense, and it's boom, 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 boom right down the field. And I'm sure there's people sitting in the stands, and I'm going to even speculate here out loud. It's like, well, heck, if it's this easy when you're in a hurry-up offense, maybe we ought to be in it a little bit more often. I mean, really, I think it's just a matter of, you know, Avon's finally getting it. Zionsville came in here and played a little bit harder. I think it's, you know, probably a little burn their side that, you know, this game right now is as close as it is. And I think Avon on this last drive here, you know, hopefully we'll get it in the end zone. It just kicked it up and played like we probably should have done the entire first half.
So first and goal from the 3, Zionsville with 1 timeout remaining. Avon with 2. They'll have 3 wideouts, 2 to the near side. Brandon Peters, he'll bend under center. He will fake the handoff, roll to the right side, and way too easy for Matt Moore. From 3 yards out, Moore's in the end zone, and the Orioles march down the field in less than 28 seconds, and they get the 6 points back that they gave up just about a minute or two ago in real time, and they're an extra point away from going back up 2 touchdowns.
Beautiful drive. You know, this is what we've seen out of Avon all year. Brandon Peters to a variety of receivers. The offensive line gave him plenty of time to get down in there close. You know, it's going to be Matt or Andrew. Little play action, naked pass that time. The guy who was supposed to be man-to-man on Matt lost him. Matt was wide open in the end zone. Brandon put it on the money.
Extra point is good, and with 32.9 seconds remaining, Avon back up on top by 2 touchdowns. We'll be back with a kick in a moment. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Avon has a rich wrestling tradition, and now Red Cobra Wrestling is proud to be a part of it. Opening last November, Red Cobra Wrestling offers training sessions run by nationally known coach Chad Red. Red Cobra Wrestling is located at 9233 East Highway 36 in Avon, across the street from Walmart and behind sidelines in the Red Brick Building. Red Cobra Wrestling offers sessions for all ages, including third grade and under and fourth grade and up. Learn more about prices, class schedules, and information at redcobrawrestlingacademy.com.
Brandon Peters hits Matt Moore from 3 yards out. Second time those two have hooked up this evening, and the Orioles back up by 14, 21-7 with 32.9 seconds remaining as Samperino gets ready to kick this one away. Put a foot into it, and this one is going to go out of bounds. So kick out of bounds, and that will give the Eagles some decent field position with 32.9 seconds remaining, down by 2 touchdowns, but only 1 timeout remaining here in this first half of play.
Well, you know, halftime, really, this is it's going to sound strange when I say it, but this is almost a head coach's dream. I'm sure Coach Bless and his staff have been trying to get the kids to listen all week and tell them that they have to play hard and do things well. We're going to go in up by 2 touchdowns here, you know, barring a late score in the first half. In a half that it's very evident we did not play our best football. So, you know, they're going to listen now. Coach Bless and his staff are going to go in and do some coaching. The kids are going to listen to the things they probably should have listened to all week, because now they know that, you know, Zionsville came in here to play and probably played about as well as they could the first half. We're still up by 14.
Lichty on the delay gives it to Mikasel. Mikasel has some running room. He'll take it up to about the midfield stripe on first and 10. Pick up 15 yards and 1 play, and 15 yards later, the Eagles are at the midfield stripe. 26.7 seconds, clock stop, as we had a hold, another big penalty for the Eagles. Did not see the penalty flag, but that one is going to be a killer as the Eagles had first and 10 at the 50-yard line, and this one's going to march it all the way back to the 29.
Well, they've hurt themselves here a little bit, and it's, you know, one of the things that makes it very difficult to move the football. But, you know, as far as their design, their game plan, I think they came in with a pretty good game plan. They mixed things up a little bit, but that's got to be, what, four or five holding penalties that we've seen already here in the first half.
So Lichty, he will set up that screen once again. This time they get it out to Mattingly. Mattingly is going to be brought down. Brody Goode in there to make the hit. Also Matt Thompson.
Yeah, Matt did a nice job playing off the blocker, but making him turn it back inside to where the pursuit was. Brody's certainly quick enough. He got out there to make the tackle.
Coach Echeverria, he's going to let him go to the locker room as we have hit halftime here at St. Vincent Health Field at Zionsville High School. Our score at the half, the Avon Orioles ranked 7th in Class 6A. They lead the 14th ranked in Class 5A Zionsville Eagles by the score of 21-7. We're going to take a timeout, pay some bills. We'll take a look at what's happening in the Hoosier Crossroads Conference in around Hendricks County when we come back. This is Oriole Football on Audio Sports Online.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954, with 8 convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900.
We'd like to thank Citywide Paving for their support of Avon Football and our Avon Football broadcast this year.
Avon Dental Center is a proud sponsor of Avon High School sports broadcast. Dr. Timothy Greer and Dr. Christopher Lefebvre have served Hendricks County families for over 20 years. Located in Avon's Beechwood Center area just east of Ivy Tech, they're open Monday through Friday, although early morning hours are available. Avon Dental Center offers high-tech dentistry that includes dental implants, orthodontics, and one-appointment crowns. At Avon Dental Center, their priority is to deliver quality care to informed patients in a comfortable and convenient setting. You can get more information at avondentalcenter.com or call for an appointment at 272-8100. Avon Dental Center.
Avon has a rich wrestling tradition, and now Red Cobra Wrestling is proud to be a part of it. Opening last November, Red Cobra Wrestling offers training sessions run by nationally known coach Chad Red. Red Cobra Wrestling is located at 9233 East Highway 36 in Avon, across the street from Walmart and behind sidelines in the red brick building. Red Cobra Wrestling offers sessions for all ages, including third grade and under and fourth grade and up. Learn more about prices, class schedules, and information at redcobrawrestlingacademy.com.
Reynolds Body Shop is a proud sponsor of Avon Football Broadcast. They are conveniently located at 4325 West Washington Street in Indianapolis, just four stoplights east of 465. Their phone is 317-243-2372, and they are open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Reynolds has been family-owned and operated for 30 years, specializing in collision repair. Reynolds Body Shop is also an insurance work specialist. Learn more about them on the web at www.reynoldsbodyshop.com.
Welcome back to St. Vincent Health Field at Zionsville High School at halftime. The Avon Orioles lead the Zionsville Eagles by the score of 21-7. This is the Oriole Halftime Report. I'm Brian Scott, taking a look at what's happening in the Hoosier Crossroads Conference as we enter play tonight. Taking a look at the standing, it's the Hamilton Southeastern Royals on top of the HCC standings with a perfect 5-0 record. They will have only one more league game to play next week. So if Avon has any hopes of at least maintaining a share of a co-championship this year, they were the sole champions last year, they will need to win tonight, and Avon would also have to win next week at home against Noblesville. Hamilton Southeastern has won their last six contests. They come in 6-1 after losing to Carmel to begin the season. They've run off six straight. They have a tough task on their hands tonight. Hamilton Southeastern is playing the non-conference game tonight. However, they're playing against a very, very good team from the state of Ohio in the Columbus, Ohio area, Columbus Bishop Hartley. They are visiting Hamilton Southeastern tonight. So a very, very tough matchup for the Royals against Hartley. HCC action tonight. Of course, the Orioles are here against the Eagles. Brownsburg is at Noblesville tonight, and the Bulldogs have a 13-3 lead there in the second quarter. Fishers is at Westfield tonight, and the Fishers Tigers, who have lost their last two games, they lead Westfield 14-7. Of course, Avon, they are in second place in the HCC, 3-1 in conference standings. Winners are their last four in a 5-2 record overall. Fishers and Brownsburg, they are tied right behind Avon with identical 2-2 records. The Tigers are 4-3 overall, however. I did mention they've lost their last two. Brownsburg 3-4 overall, but the Bulldogs have won their last two. Westfield is 2-3 in the conference standings, 4-3 overall, but the Shamrocks have lost their last three games. Noblesville is the Orioles' opponent next week to close out the regular season. Noblesville 1-3 in conference play, 3-4 overall, and the Millers have lost their last two games. And of course, the Eagles round out the HCC conference standings, winless in conference play, 0-4 and 3-4 overall. And the Eagles have lost their last three matchups. Games of last week: Avon defeated Westfield 35-20, Brownsburg defeated Zionsville 66-41, Hamilton Southeastern defeated Noblesville 20-12, and Cathedral beat Fishers 35-6. The 2016 IHSAA regular season will end next week. One of the big games will be really at a neutral site. It will take place at Victory Field. Hamilton Southeastern will take on the Brownsburg Bulldogs at Victory Field to close out the season. The Orioles will host Noblesville. Westfield will play the non-conference game as they will wrap up their HCC schedule tonight. Westfield will be at Brebeuf Jesuit, and the Fishers Tigers will host the Zionsville Eagles. And that is how the regular season will wrap up in the Hoosier Crossroads Conference. Taking a look at action around Hendricks County, we mentioned Brownsburg leading Noblesville 13-3 in the second quarter. Of course, here at the half, the Orioles lead the Eagles 21-7. Plainfield is at Whiteland. This is a team that Oriole fans saw a few weeks ago, and Avon absolutely destroyed Whiteland. Since then, Whiteland has won a couple straight. They're ranked sixth in Class 5A, and they have a 10-7 lead over the Plainfield Quakers, who many people, if they saw that first game of the season, Avon versus Plainfield, didn't think Plainfield was that good of a team. But head coach Brian Woodard has put a pretty good team on the field, and they've been playing very good football. Plainfield enters tonight's game with a record of 4-3, 2-2 in mid-state conference action. The Danville Warriors got off the schneid last week. They picked up their first win of the season, 1-6 now on the year, 1-4 in Sagamore Conference action after defeating Frankfort last week, 49-34. The Warriors are at home tonight, but they got a tough matchup on their hands. They will host the Western Boone Stars, who are ranked 12th in Class 3A. The Stars are 6-1 overall, 5-0 in Sagamore Conference play. Western Boone defeated North Montgomery last week, 28-14. The Tri-West Bruins, well, they were last year's Class 3A champion, preseason Class 3A number one. They've long since fallen out of the rankings, but they've been winning some football games of late. They've won their last two as they defeated Southmont last week, 47-21, to put the Bruins back over the 500 mark at 4-3 on the season. And 4-1 in Sagamore Conference play. They host Crawfordsville tonight. The Athenians 3-4 overall, 2-3 in conference play. And the Bruins in the second quarter, or at the half, excuse me, I believe, had a 28 4-0 league. And finally, the Cascade Cadets, they've had a bit of an up-and-down year. The Cadets now 3-4 on the year, 2-2 in Western Indiana Conference action. They've lost their last two. They lost to North Putnam last week, 24-14. They are hosting the Mustangs of Edgewood, who host an identical record. So this is an Eastern Division of the Western Indiana Conference matchup taking place tonight at Cascade. Again, our score at the half, the Avon Orioles lead the Zionsville Eagles 21-7. We come back. Coach and I will talk about what we saw in the first half and what we might expect to see in the second half. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954, with 8 convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900.
We'd like to thank Citywide Paving for their support of Avon Football and our Avon Football broadcast this year.
Avon Dental Center is a proud sponsor of Avon High School sports broadcast. Dr. Timothy Greer and Dr. Christopher LaFave have served Hendricks County families for over 20 years. Located in Avon's Beechwood Center area just east of Ivy Tech, they're open Monday through Friday, although early morning hours are available. Avon Dental Center offers high-tech dentistry that includes dental implants, orthodontics, and one-appointment crowns. At Avon Dental Center, their priority is to deliver quality care to informed patients in a comfortable and convenient setting. You can get more information at avondentalcenter.com or call for an appointment at 272-8100. Avon Dental Center.
Avon has a rich wrestling tradition, and now Red Cobra Wrestling is proud to be a part of it. Opening last November, Red Cobra Wrestling offers training sessions run by nationally known coach Chad Red. Red Cobra Wrestling is located at 9233 East Highway 36 in Avon, across the street from Walmart and behind sidelines in the Red Brick Building. Red Cobra Wrestling offers sessions for all ages, including third grade and under and fourth grade and up. Learn more about prices, class schedules, and information at RedCobraWrestlingAcademy.com.
Reynolds Body Shop is a proud sponsor of Avon Football Broadcast. They are conveniently located at 4325 West Washington Street in Indianapolis, just four stoplights east of 465. Their phone is 317-243-2372, and they are open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Reynolds has been family-owned and operated for 30 years, specializing in collision repair. Reynolds Body Shop is also an insurance work specialist. Learn more about them on the web at www.reynoldsbodyshop.com.
Halftime at Zionsville. The Avon Orioles lead the Zionsville Eagles by the score of 21-7. This is the Oriole Halftime Show. I'm Brian Scott. I'm joined by Dave Shelbourne. As we look at what we saw in the first half, and really for a quarter and almost a half, we didn't see a whole lot. Both teams had problems finding their offense in the first quarter of play. Though Zionsville took the opening kickoff and marched right down the field, really shocking the Orioles, I think, to some point. But the Eagles could get it no closer than to fourth and goal inside the one, and Zach Batustek made a fantastic play on Brendan Michelsoldt, knocking him down in the backfield for about a four-yard loss, and that's really until late in the first half, as close as the Eagles would sniff the end zone for much of the first half. Orioles, they had their own problems, though, offensively. They really couldn't get anything going. In fact, they wouldn't get anything going offensively. It would be a 43-yard punt return for a touchdown by Brian Fitzgerald at the 7:27 mark in the second quarter that gave Avon their first points of the football game as they led 7-0. Orioles wouldn't get their first offensive touchdown until a minute 55 left to go in the first half when Brandon Heaters hit Matt Moore on a 7-yard touchdown pass, and Avon had a 14-0 lead. But Zionsville marched it right back down the field. They end up getting a touchdown when Eddie Mattingly took the pitch from the quarterback threw the touchdown pass to Holden Hodge in the end zone, 26-yard touchdown pass. Ryan Stein's point after made it 14-7, and the Eagles looked like they had a bit of life, but they had to kick the ball back to Avon and Avon had it first and 10 with about 55 seconds left to go, plenty of time with all three timeouts, and Brandon Peters just marched the offense right down the field. He got a couple of nice completions. Found Andrew Griffin on a couple of plays. Found Matt Moore on a nice play down the sideline. And eventually, Matt Moore would be on the receiving end of a wide open pass from Brandon Peters from 3 yards out. And with 32 seconds left to go in the first half, Avon put the lead back up to 2 touchdowns, 21-7. And I bring in the Indiana Football Hall of Famer Dave Shelbourne as we look at the first half. We said at the end of one quarter that if the game was tied, it might have been a mild shock, but if the game was scoreless after first quarter, we were going to be more than shocked. But here we are now after two quarters of play. Avon with a 2-touchdown lead, 21-7, but it hasn't come easy and it hasn't been pretty.
Yeah, it's been ugly. Avon didn't play the kind of half I'm sure that the coaches expected, the fans expected, or, you know, that we expected doing a broadcast, but the second quarter, they showed flashes of what they're capable of doing. I often joke they got a master's in guidance so I could be a high school head football coach and should have gotten a doctorate because, you know, so much of this really doesn't have a whole lot to do with coaching. They're running the same plays. You know, they're executing the same way. You know, it's that mental, it's that mental frame of mind you bring to a game. And I don't know if, Avon came in here tonight on an off week or getting ready for playoffs or, you know, looking at the fact that Zionsville's lost the last couple of games or they saw Brownsburg put up 60-some points against them last week. But Avon did not play the kind of first quarter that, you know, we certainly anticipated. The second quarter, they showed some flashes of being the Avon that we think they can be. You know, Brian Fitzgerald made the great run on the punt return and, we got the passing game kind of kicked into gear there a little bit more with, Andrew hitting Matt Moore for 2 touchdowns and moving the football around to some other people. But, you know, the ground game hasn't been at least what I anticipated, especially with Zionsville playing really just a three down front. And Zionsville has moved the football even without scoring on the Avon defense a little bit easier than I thought they might be capable of. But, you know, Avon has done a nice job, really, of keeping them off the board. And other than the one, halfback pass where, you know, we just kind of lost sight of the receiver, the defense overall has played well. So I mentioned right before the half and the break that, you know, this is a great, great, great teaching moment for Coach Bless and his staff. You know, you're up by 2 touchdowns, and, you know, the game certainly is not over. But, you know, you've got a little bit of a comfort zone here and that you're up by 2 scores and you're getting the ball back. But I'm sure they're in there right now, lighting them up, motivating them, however you want to word it. They're probably having a little bit easier time getting their attention at halftime than they did during the week. The execution is not bad. It's just not as sharp as they're capable of. And Avon's got some outstanding athletes, and they just need to shine here in the second half.
And it could also be taken just as far. There's a couple of very nice fourth down defensive plays that that stopped the Eagles. The Eagles have also, they've done a fair job of stopping themselves, especially with some holding penalties on some drives. And they had almost that disaster, of course, that led to the, it eventually led to Fitzgerald's punt return for a touchdown, but they end up going backwards, almost having the ball blocked and returned for a touchdown. They get it out, but in the end they punt it, and it ends up in the end zone anyway. So a couple of good plays by the Oriole defense on big fourth down conversions, and the Eagles not getting quite out of their own way at times, and this could be still a very different ball game.
Well, I mean, you know, we still have a half to play, and you're never sure who's going to come out or how they're going to play in the second half, but you know, your goal as a coaching staff is just to get your kids to play as well as they can play. Avon, for whatever reasons, didn't play as well as they could play the first half. You know, we showed signs of it. We had plays where we looked just fabulous. But you know, the whole key from a coach's point of view is to be consistent, do it every play. You know, it's kind of a percentage game. You know, you want to execute and do your best, you know, 80 to 90% of the plays. And, you know, I'd say the first half for Avon, you know, we're maybe, you know, looking at 50%. So I'm sure that it's not so much adjustments or, you know, they lined up this way or we need to block this guy the second half. I think it's just really a consistency thing that we've got to bring it to the house, you know, every play. And, you know, we've just got to continue to play as hard. Really, the first quarter especially, Zionsville played very hard. The second quarter, I think we maybe took a little bit out of them when we put the scores up. But, you know, this third quarter, you know, we either like last week, you know, where we let Westfield back in the game, or hopefully, you know, we'll come out the third quarter like we did. I can't remember which game where we put up, you know, we put up 30-some points, I think, in the third quarter and just put the game away. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of attitude Avon comes out with in the third quarter.
Well, both teams have made their way out onto the field. It was a rather lengthy halftime here at Zionsville. It is senior night, their final home game here. So the band was out here. They've been having a senior night festivities. But both teams back out onto the field as we get ready for second half action. So we will take a timeout. We come back. We'll have the second half kickoff as the Orioles lead the Eagles 21-7. This is Oriole Football on Audio Sports Online.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954, with 8 convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900.
We'd like to thank Citywide Paving for their support of Avon Football and our Avon Football broadcast this year.
Avon Dental Center is a proud sponsor of Avon High School sports broadcast. Dr. Timothy Greer and Dr. Christopher LaFave have served Hendricks County families for over 20 years. Located in Avon's Beechwood Center area just east of Ivy Tech, they're open Monday through Friday, although early morning hours are available. Avon Dental Center offers high-tech dentistry that includes dental implants, orthodontics, and one-appointment crowns. At Avon Dental Center, their priority is to deliver quality care to informed patients in a comfortable and convenient setting. You can get more information at avondentalcenter.com or call for an appointment at 272-8100. Avon Dental Center.
Avon has a rich wrestling tradition, and now Red Cobra Wrestling is proud to be a part of it.
Opening last November, Red Cobra Wrestling offers training sessions run by nationally known coach Chad Red. Red Cobra Wrestling is located at 9233 East Highway 36 in Avon, across the street from Walmart and behind sidelines in the Red Brick Building. Red Cobra Wrestling offers sessions for all ages, including third grade and under and fourth grade and up. Learn more about prices, class schedules, and information at RedCobraWrestlingAcademy.com.
Reynolds Body Shop is a proud sponsor of Avon Football Broadcast. They are conveniently located at 4325 West Washington Street in Indianapolis, just four stoplights east of 465. Their phone is 317-243-2372, and they are open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Reynolds has been family-owned and operated for 30 years, specializing in collision repair. Reynolds Body Shop is also an insurance work specialist. Learn more about them on the web at www.reynoldsbodyshop.com. Welcome back to St. Vincent Health at Zionsville High School as we get ready for second half action. Alongside the Indiana Football Hall of Famer Dave Shelbourne, I'm Brian Scott. Avon leading 21-7, and they will receive the football to begin the second half. They will move into the wind again. It's not as stiff of the wind as we had last week at Avon, in which it was a good steady 25-30 miles per hour, but it is 15-20 miles per hour. It has affected some of the kicks into the wind, and the Orioles will be moving into that wind to begin the fourth quarter as Ryan Stein gets ready to kick this one off. I noticed that Stein was practicing kicking into the wind field goals from about the 25-yard line before second half, and he was getting it up there from about 35 yards out into the wind, and he will kick off to begin the second half, and that ball will go into the end zone via a touchback is how the Orioles will start the second half. First and 10 from their own 20-yard line. They're up by two touchdowns as we begin the third quarter. And, Coach, it's probably wanting to see Avon really get something started really fast here on offense to begin this drive. You expect them to maybe see if they can get this ball down the field rather quickly?
I think they'll be patient here. What's important is at the end of the drive is they get a touchdown. So I think they'll mix it up. They probably made a few adjustments at halftime, but there's no hurry. Zionsville's, playing back pretty far, so I think they'll take their time here and go down the field on the first play.
On the very first play, Harrison Weber has it for a pickup of about 50 yards down to the Zionsville 33-yard line.
Guess I didn't call that one, did I? they went for the throw on the first play. I mean, I'm a little bit surprised they're back there playing too deep with two safeties way deep, but, the play action fake was good enough to get the safeties to buy it. Harrison can certainly run. He ran right by his guy, and Brandon put the ball on the money.
And the one thing that was a little different about that play is we saw Brandon. He was under center. Now he'll be out in the gun with three wide outs, a play action, fakes it to Love. There's Jordan Peterson wide alone on the far side. Peterson will pick up about 12 yards, another first down for Avon, and two plays in there within the red zone of Zionsville.
Yeah, well, he threw a big tight spiral into the wind also. I mean, that was probably a good, 45, 50-yard throw into the wind and put it right on the money for Harrison. So evidently, Coach Morin and Coach Bless and the staff have decided to go for the throat here a little bit, and I think you're right. It looks like they're trying to score here in a hurry and get the momentum back their way.
They spotted the ball at the 21-yard line, first and 10. Darian Love to the right of Brandon Peters. He'll get the ball. He'll run left side. Matt Moore blocking. Darian tried to turn it inside the tackle, and he'll gain a couple of yards, maybe inside to about the 17-yard line to pick up a 3, maybe 4 yards, second and 6.
Yeah, Matt, is a versatile enough kid. He's kind of an H-back tight end, wide receiver. He can do an awful lot of things. Normally a team would have to sub to put three different people in there to do all the things Matt's capable of doing. When he lines up in the backfield, he really lines up right behind the offensive line. You can pretty well count on him being a blocker.
Two wide outs to the far side, one to the near side. Brandon back to pass, second and 6. All the time in the world, pass tip at the line of scrimmage. It looked like getting a hand up might have been Scott Fuller. a 6'2", 225-pound senior defensive lineman. That'll bring up third and six.
Well, you know, the concept that they're running here, they ran what I would call a switch route. They took the two outside receivers and they just kind of crisscrossed and ran deep. And if they can get one of them open, they're certainly going to take the home run. But they ran with them, so right behind that, they're running an underneath route with that time with Jordan Peterson. And he was open, but they knocked the ball down. Otherwise, it would have been a big game.
Weber and Matt Moore to the far side. Griffin and Peterson to the near side. Darian Love to the left. Peters back to pass. Fires out right side. Pass complete. Matt Moore dives inside. Spins down to about the 8-yard line. It'll be first and goal, Avon.
Nice little quick out, little timing route, kind of a catch and throw. Matt just took it up the field about 5 yards and bended his route a little bit to the outside. Once he made the turn, Brandon put the ball on the money and an easy pickup for the first down. And, you know, this is the Avon offense that we've been used to seeing most of the year. They're clicking on all cylinders. They're running up, you know, back and forth to the line of scrimmage, and, you know, they look like they're playing with a good rhythm right now.
Three wideouts to the near side. Peters back to pass. Fires over the middle. Easy touchdown. Matt Moore has his third touchdown reception of the night, this one from 8 yards out. And Avon takes less than 2 minutes, actually about a minute and 45 seconds, to go down the field and put up their, make this a three-touchdown advantage pending Matt Perino's point after.
And that was just a beautiful route. I mean, people can't play him one-on-one. I mean, after, you know, watching 7-8 games this year, you think they'd know that. He went down straight up the field, got a clean release, made a little move like he was going to go to the corner. The DB bit, he bent it right back to the middle, was wide open. As soon as he turned, the ball was on the money.
Sam Perino's point after is good. And with 10:16 left to go in the third quarter, the Orioles extend their lead to 3 touchdowns, 28-7. We'll have the kickoff in a second. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
Sam Perino with a kickoff as he'll kick this one deep and he'll send it to the right side. It'll take a bounce and it'll be touched before it went out of bounds. So a mistake there by Zionsville, as I believe the return man, which was might have been Brock Bishop, he thought it was going to go out of bounds or whatever, but he touched it and then sent it out of bounds. So the Eagles will have the football, but they'll have it back at around their own 10-yard line.
Well, this is when it starts to happen. You know, Avon takes that drive down and, you know, about a minute 45, and it looks like the Avon we think we're going to see, and Zionsville comes back again, and that's nothing that will show up in you know, on the score sheet, but that's a mental error that just cost them 25 yards, gives them poor field position, and if they end up going three and out and kicking, they're going to give Avon the ball inside the 50-yard line with great field position for their second drive.
They spotted it at the 16, and as the man who came in motion from the far side, I believe Eddie Mattingly, was expecting that ball to be snapped. He had made his turn upfield, and it goes from bad to worse.
Other self-destructing. This is, you know, this is that mental game that we talked about a little bit the first half, where they came out so sharp mentally. They were into it the first half, and second half, we've already got two mental errors here, and, you know, they haven't even really run a play.
So make it first and 15. The ball back at the 6-yard line after the penalty. Trips wide to the near side. Lichty fires. He's looking for a matchup down the field, one-on-one. Penalty flag back at the 19-yard line.
Get a hold on Avon.
As they once again, Lechte looking for the receiver on the left side. And they'll call pass interference against Avon and saying that the ball was in the air when the defensive back made contact. So they'll call the pass interference, which is a 15-yard penalty, and That'll give the Eagles some breathing room up to near the 21-yard line where they'll have it first and 10.
Yeah, they set that up the whole first half. They went short on that side, I don't know, four, five, six times. So it was just a matter of time before they were going to try and go deep. They decided to do it on their first play of the second half.
So three wideouts to the far side as Lichty works with first and 10. He will roll out to the near side. Pass is complete to Mike Hassel. Mike Hassel will be blown up after a short gain. Scott Campbell there to make the tackle. Also Brian Fitzgerald. It'll be a pickup of a short gain of about 2 yards, make it second and 8 for the Eagles.
Yeah, played extremely well in the open field. He was open initially right off the line of scrimmage. They got the ball out, and Scott Campbell and Brian Fitzgerald just ran him down in a hurry in the open field.
Trips to the left, single wide out to the near side. Orioles show blitz, but they'll throw it near side. Here's Holden Hodge as he gets past Scott Campbell, who stumbled and allowed Hodge to get behind him. Or actually, it's Jay Edwards as the ball is the receiver, and Edwards will take it to the 40-yard line where it'll be first and 10 for the Eagles. They will quickly head to the line of scrimmage as they spot the ball at the 40-yard line, first and 10. Avon leads 28-7. An 8-yard touchdown pass from Brandon Peters to Matt Moore capped a very fast opening drive here in the second half for the Orioles. This is the Eagles' first possession. Here is a pass right through Brody Goode's hands as he slapped himself. He had the ball in his hands. Pass was intended over there on that far side, I believe. Might have been Jay or Holden Hodge. Again, very difficult to read these numbers with the dark numbers with just wide outlines.
Yeah, Brody can catch. When I had him in seventh grader, he was a wide receiver also before he got that big body. So he can catch the football.
Again, trips to the left. They'll set up the screen, and it will be blown up. It took so long to develop. The Orioles just kind of waited for the ball to come down and then tackled the receiver for about a 2-yard loss. They let the Orioles come in, but it was a kind of a floating pass by Lichty, and the Orioles just kind of waited for the ball to come down and tackle the receiver. Loss of 2, 3rd and 12 for the Eagles. 8:55 left to go, third quarter. Avon up 28-7. Lichty has Mikasell to his left. Three wide receivers at the top of the formation, one to the bottom. Lichty fires near side. Pass intended for Edwards, incomplete. Scott Campbell in good coverage, and that'll bring up fourth down for Zionsville. And on comes the punting unit for Coach Patch Echeverria.
Actually, Coach Etch was a fraternity brother and football player with my son at DePauw, so I've known Coach since his college days where he was a really outstanding football player for the DePauw Tigers.
Brian Stein set to kick this one away. Brian Fitzgerald, who already has a punt return for a touchdown, back deep with Matt Moore. And this one, bad snap, and Stein's going to be able to get it off as this one was just rolled back to him. It'll take a hop and will be downed at about the 38-yard line. Ryan Stein has had his adventures back there in the punt, in his punting duties, a lot of it not through no fault really of his own. He's had some bad snaps. He's had bad field position. He's had poor blocking on the block punt by Scott Campbell.
He's had to be an athlete back there, but he was really pretty lucky because he did go down on his knee to try to field the ball, and because the ball bounced up to him, he came off the knee. If he had not come off the knee, Avon would have gained 30 yards.
As it is, the Orioles will have it first and 10 from their own 39, up by three touchdowns with 8:35 left to go third quarter. Peters back to pass, has all day and a half, still back there. Good coverage downfield, and now Brandon will dive forward. Great protection by the Oriole offensive line, but good coverage downfield by the Eagles. Brandon gets what he can, which is about 5 yards. It'll bring up give him 4 yards, second and 6.
Yeah, similar concept to some of the plays they had run the first half. They had trips to the field, ran all three receivers deep. They lined up Matt Moore as a tight end, which we don't see a whole lot with Matt, but he lined up on the short side, and he ran a drag route all the way across the field, and Zionsville's linebackers, I think, have figured out they're looking to get him the ball. They picked him up, so he was covered as well, which forced Brandon to put the ball away and run.
Corey DePriest, the lone tailback on second and six. Play action pass. Peters down the middle. Has Harrison Weber, and Harrison, a great job of concentration. He got popped as soon as the ball hit his hands, but he held on, got popped again, and it's a big gain all the way down to the Eagle 32-yard line.
Well, if you're Avon, you have to like everything about that play. Great fake, great protection out of the offensive line. The throw couldn't be any better, and Harrison caught the ball in traffic and hung on to the football. So everything Avon had to do to complete that play, they did.
It's the first and 10 Avon at the Eagle 32-yard line. A score here would really put the Eagles in a bit of a hole if being down three touchdowns wasn't enough. Here's Corey DePriest slashing through the offensive line, finds the hole, and takes it down to the Eagle 25-yard line to pick up a seven. It'll be second down and three.
Yeah, nice pull that time. They ran a little counter play. Andrew Reed, senior left guard, pulled around to the outside, allowed DePriest to cut it back in for a good gain on first down.
So second down and three as the Orioles on their opening drive just rammed it down the Eagles' throats. And this one, now they have it second and three at the Eagle 25. Two wideouts to the near side as Peters back to pass. Great protection once again, but good coverage. Brandon rolls. He's going to have plenty of room. He'll take it near side. He'll get a great block. Take it down the sideline. He will dive into the end zone.
Touchdown. That's a touchdown.
And now there's a penalty flag back at the 17-yard line. The signal was touchdown, and now Peters is down on the field. So the call on the field was touchdown, but they're going to bring this one back. Peters got a great block. I didn't see who it was from, whether it was Matt Moore. It's an illegal block.
Well, I'm sure they'll look at that on film, but when I first thought it looked like he got his head in front, obviously the official didn't agree with our observation.
So the penalty flag was back at the 17-yard line. Again, good coverage downfield by the Eagles, but Brandon found some running room, and then I think it was Matt Moore that might have peeled off and leveled a block. That freed Brandon down the near sideline, but evidently they said maybe it was an illegal block from the back, and the penalty is going to put the ball back at the 27-yard line where it will still be second down, and now it's second down and five, so a net loss of two on the play.
What a run, though. I mean, everybody knows how well he can throw the football. I don't think many people realize the athletic ability and his ability to run the football in the open field as well.
DePriest remains the tailback. Four wideouts, two to each side on second and five. Play action pass down the middle, looking for Jordan Peterson, and it's an easy 27-yard touchdown pass. Brandon Peters to Jordan Peterson, and now the Orioles piling it on here in the third quarter.
Yeah, that's just, that little seam route. They've run the three and four receivers deep here most of the night because Zionsville's playing in the two deep, and then they're just reading off the safeties. Great read. Got a free run down the field. Nice route by Jordan Peterson, and a great catch in a little bit of traffic, but protection was good and the throw was on the money as expected.
Perino on for the point after, and he will sneak it through for the fifth time today.
Well, yeah, my hat's off to Coach Bluss. I mean, whatever he said to him at halftime, he certainly lit a fire under him, because we've come out here really in the first 5.5 minutes of the second half and just played flawless football.
Our score was 6:31 left to go. Third quarter, Avon 35, Zionsville 7. Back with a kick in a moment. This is Oriole Football on ASO.
We'd like to thank Citywide Paving for their support of Avon Football and our Avon Football broadcast this year.
6:31 remains in this third quarter. All Avon now 35-7 as Brandon Peters has connected on four touchdown passes tonight. Three to Matt Moore, one to Jordan Peterson. A Brian Fitzgerald punt return for a touchdown accounts for the fifth score. And now the Orioles, who've come out on a house of fire here in this third quarter, are kicking off once again. as this ball will once again bounce. It will be picked up on a bounce, going backwards and going the wrong way as the ball carrier. Ramsey is going to try to make the edge, and he will be fortunate to get it back to about the 20-yard line.
Yeah, run down by Chad Carpenter. Nice run by Chad.
And the Eagles, who have had nothing to talk about here in this second half, they got to score late in that first half to at least have a little bit of life. But they have watched the Orioles on two possessions here in the second half just run it right down their throats. And now Avon leads 35-7 as once again Lichty and the Eagle offense is back out on the field. This time he'll bring in running backs to the left and right. They'll send Mattingly in motion. They'll give it to Michelson. Michelson will go right up the middle and pick up about four.
Yeah, the run game has been pretty well shut down here. The Avon down three are getting after it pretty good. And really after the first drive of the game, Avon's really done a pretty good job defensively.
So a four-yard pickup for Brendan Michelson, and it will bring up second down and about six. Trips to the left. They'll bring Mattingly in motion. And they'll give it to Michelson, who will be spun around by A.J. Elcock. And good job by Brendan Michelson because he kept his feet. And actually, the play was going one way. He took Elcock's momentum and spun it the other way and picks up a first down.
Well, they're hanging in there, but right now I think Zionsville is just trying to establish a little rhythm of their own. You know, there's still half the third quarter to go. There's no need to panic, even though you're down. What they really want to do here is get back in their offensive rhythm.
Mattingly in motion. They'll fake the sweep. Here's a penalty flag. They have a man wide open at the 35-yard line, as I believe it was Mattingly who was, they faked the jet sweep to, but personal foul, a blow to the head by Avon. So a penalty against Avon, in which they called a blow to the head. And that is going to give the Eagles 15 yards. Saw C.J. Hunt kind of lifting his hands up, and then he went off to the sidelines. And the Eagles have it first and 10 from their own 47-yard line. 5:35 left to go, third quarter. Avon with two touchdowns here in the third quarter to extend their lead to 35-7. Mattingly in motion to give us to Michelson. He'll look for some room. We'll find very little of it as the Orioles penetrate there at the line of scrimmage to hold Michelson to no gain. It'll be second and 10.
Yeah, they've heated it up here in the second half. Those down three from Avon are getting after it a little bit. And, you know, Zionsville's offensive line early moved the football, but Avon has certainly kicked up the intensity here the second half.
They'll give Michelson about a yard, call it second and nine for the Eagles. This time they'll use double wings as Lichty back to pass, fires over the middle, has a nice catch as Brody Good will have to bring Mattingly down from behind on a nice pitch and catch as Lichty fired a strike right over the middle. Mattingly brought it in, and it's a big gain down into the Oriole territory to about the 26-yard line, first and 10 Eagles.
Yeah, man-to-man coverage, and, you know, Brody's fast enough to run with him and did. He caught him from behind, but he made a quick little move off the line of scrimmage to get open, caught an open shoulder. Quarterback put the ball on the money for a big game, but Brody did chase him down.
Mattingly comes out as the Eagles have it first and 10. They'll give it to Michelson, who will take it right up the middle. And he will be down at the 22-yard line. Ball might have come out, but the official here on the near side saying that the runner was down. So it's a pickup of about 3 yards on the play. It'll call second and 7 with the ball spotted about the 23-yard line.
Yeah, Zionsville's goal right now is to score, is to put points up on the board. Have a nice drive, do whatever they need to do. Quite honestly, I don't think they're as worried about the clock right now as they are about just establishing, again, that little offensive rhythm and seeing if they can put a touchdown up on the board.
Avon will call a timeout. A.J. Elcock was coming off of the field very late. So either some confusion about who was supposed to be in that defensive package. The Orioles use a timeout. We'll take a timeout as well with 3:58 remaining in the third quarter. All Avon, they lead Zionsville 35-7. Back in a moment. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, light housekeeping, companionship, and much more. Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
Avon uses a timeout. The defensive package may be confusion as far as personnel. They use the first of their three as the Eagles have it at their own 20, at the Oriole 22-yard line at second down and six. Mickelson will be Lichty will be flanked left and right. Two wideouts to the top of the formation, one to the bottom. Lichty back to pass. He fires, looking for a corner out, and he overthrows his intended receiver, which I believe was Holden Hodge.
Yeah, ran a corner route, and he was open. Just didn't quite wasn't quite able to put the ball on the money, but nice route, good protection, and you know could have been a touchdown.
Incomplete pass will make it third down. And about 6 yards to go for the Eagles. Again, they trail 35-7. It was 21-7 at the half, and then the Orioles held in their two drives here in this third quarter have just marched it down the field. Play action pass, Lichty looking downfield, pass incomplete.
I was going to say, that's got to be interference.
Looking for Brock Bishop, but Ian Pendleton in coverage, but a penalty flag at the 5-yard line, and that's going to go against Pendleton and the Orioles.
A little aggressive on the coverage there. You know, as my buddy up here in the box said, probably didn't need to be, but he definitely did grab him. Yeah, while I'm giving shout-outs, I want to give a shout-out to Ryan, my golf pro. He said he was going to listen to me tonight. I'm going to check him out the next time I go out.
So the penalty will give the Eagles a first down as the ball will be spotted at the Oriole 12-yard line. 3:49 remain in the third quarter. Avon up 35-7.
Checking scores here while we're waiting. Good night for the Lawrence schools. Lawrence Central is tied with Ben Davis in the third, and Lawrence North is playing Center Grove here pretty close.
Mattingly on the jet sweep, turns it up the field, and he will get it down inside the five, down to about the 2 or 3 yard line on a play that we've seen them run a couple of times. And once they allowed Mattingly to throw out of that formation, and he hit the only touchdown of the night for the Eagles when he had Holden Hodge in the end zone. So Mattingly will take it down. They'll spot the ball at the 4 yard line. It'll bring up second down and a long one, maybe 2 yards to go for the Eagles. Oriole shifting around defensively. They'll bring Mattingly once again in motion. Lichty to pass, quick strike, looking for Mattingly, but Mattingly was turned the wrong way.
Yeah, good play, little rub play because you can't pick. But two of the receivers down there did run routes very close to each other. It did free up the receiver coming out of the backfield. He was open, just a little miscue on the throw.
So that's going to bring up third down, and again, long one, short 2 yards for the Eagles. They can get a first down if they can get it inside the 3 yard line. They'll bring Mattingly once again in motion. Lichty will give it to Michelson. Michelson will turn it up. He has the first down. He'll keep his legs churning. And
looks like he's in.
They will spot him just outside the end zone. But it will be a first down. It'll be first and goal for the Eagles as Mike Gasol looked like he was in. Neither of the head linesman or the line judge made a signal until one came in and said he was just shy. So the ball, nose of the football is about as close to the goal line as you can get.
Brownsburg big, 33-3 over Noblesville right now.
Of course, the Millers will be at Avon next week to close out the regular season. Mattingly in motion on first and goal. Here's Mikasol, and he will walk it in from 1 yard out as Brendan Mikasol gets the Eagles on the scoreboard in the second half from 1 yard out with 2:41 remaining in the third quarter. So a nice drive by the Eagles as they take it down the field. And Brendan Mikasol caps it off with a one-yard touchdown run, and Ryan Stein will be on for the point after.
Well, that's a confidence builder. I'm sure that's what the Zionsville staff, at least at this point in the game, wanted. Let's just be methodical. Let's mix things up. Let's just prove that we can move the football and score, and they've done that. This next drive, this next possession for Avon will probably pretty much determine whether, you know, there's enough time left for them to get back in the game. If they can stop Avon on the next drive, they've got a chance. If Avon takes it down the field, they'll be in trouble.
Ryan Stein's point after is good. And with 2:41 left to go, third quarter, Avon still out in front, 35-14. Back with a kick in a moment. This is Oriole football on ASO.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954, with 8 convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900.
Trevor Lichten and the Eagles get on the scoreboard here in the second half as Brendan Mikasol runs it in from 1 yard out. The Orioles still well out in front, 35-14 with 2:41 left to go in the third quarter. Alongside the Indiana Football Hall of Famer Dave Shelbourne, I'm Brian Scott. As Ryan Stein ready to kick this football away, and he puts a boot into it, and Brian Fitzgerald will watch it sail out of the end zone for a touchback. As Fitzgerald was really the single safety back deep, but Stein with the wind at his back puts it through the end zone. It's been a steady wind. Again, probably not as breezy as it was at Avon last Friday against Westfield, but still a nice stiff wind that once the football gets up in the air, we've seen it knock it down heading into the wind and get a bit of a boost from behind. But Brandon Peters so far, it has not affected his throwing. And he has the Oriole offense back out onto the field. First and 10 from their own 20-yard line with trips to the near side. And Darian Love, the tailback. Here's Love. He'll bounce off a tackle, and he'll gain 7 yards on first down.
Yeah, nice little, you know, little guard around power play, little inside counter play. Avon obviously wants to get some time off the clock. You know, you want to win the football game. You'd like to establish that rhythm in your offense. But, again, this late in the season, you want to come out of here as healthy as you can as well.
Weber and Peterson to the far side. Andrew Griffin to the near side. Love remains the tailback on this second down and 3. As we approach the 2-minute mark left to go third quarter, Darian with the carry. Big hole right up the middle, and Darian will have a first down and more out beyond the 30 to the 35-yard line. Good hole opened up on that left side of the offensive line where Nick Shoemaker and Andrew Reed, who's getting the start this week, opened up a nice hole, and Darian just drove right through it. So first and 10, Avon ball at the 35-yard line as we're under 2 minutes left to go third quarter. Weber will go to the far side, Peterson and Griffin to the near side, and Darian Love will remain the tailback on this first and 10, looking over that three-down Eagle front. Eagles show some pressure from the outside. And Darian will take the ball. He'll go over the right side, and he will pick up another good chunk, a good 4 yards on the play near the 40-yard line, going over that right side where D.J. Bowles and Addison Batten, the two freshmen, have resided. And They have played every snap pretty much of every down all season. And as Coach mentioned, after pretty much the first quarter of week one against Plainfield, they weren't freshmen any longer. They've been playing varsity football all season long.
They've been playing very well and, you know, been playing very steady football. They've proven that they're good, solid 6A linemen. They're only going to get better.
Second down and six. Peters back to pass. Right side ball tip at the line of scrimmage is getting a football, or getting a hand up on the football with Scott Fuller, the 6'2", 225-pound senior defensive lineman. I believe that's the second time he's gotten a paw up there to knock down a Peters pass. And then bring up third down and about five for Avon. 54.4 seconds remain in this third quarter. Avon up 35-14 and facing third down. Weber and Peterson to the far side, Griffin to the near side, Matt Moore will line up tight end left. Darian Love the tailback on third down. Brandon will take the snap, drop back to pass. He'll low fire right side, pass incomplete. He was looking for Jordan Peterson over there on that far side, and they miss on that one. It'll bring up fourth down. Jared Wisniewski also in there for coverage for the Eagles, but fourth down, and Samperino will kick with the wind in his face and 49.7 seconds remaining on the third quarter clock. Looks like Nolan Ellsbury back deep for the Eagles. He'll stand back at around his 29-yard line. Perino will stand at about his 26. He will get this ball, a low bouncer. It'll take a bounce and go take a little bit of an eagle bounce, but it will die at about the 34-yard line, and that's where Lichty and the Eagles will take possession with 41.1 seconds remaining in the third quarter. They trail Avon by 21, but they have the football. And they will have the wind at their backs for the remaining 41 seconds of this third quarter. Lichty led the offense down the field on their last drive. It was capped off by a one-yard Brendan Michelson run that cut it to 21 points, the deficit for the Eagles, after the Orioles put up touchdowns on their first two drives of the half. Now lifting the offense back out onto the field with trips to the near side. They'll set up that screen once again, and once again, Matt Thompson is there to blow it up.
Yeah, I don't think they're used to blocking somebody like Matt out there. Like I said, usually it's a little scrawny DB. It's not, you know, it's not a linebacker. They've got Matt, really. Matt's playing, and this shows what kind of an athlete he is. He's playing a different position tonight. He's actually playing the position normally that Brian Fitzgerald's playing, because they've got him back playing free safety. So Matt's actually playing kind of that hybrid position. He's a DB linebacker because he's got the speed and athletic ability to be able to do it.
Second and 10 is Lichty back to pass. Pump fakes, looks, fires, has a man wide open. He lays it in there at about the 48-yard line, and it's a big gain as pass is complete. It's to Jay Edwards over there on the far sideline. He took a pop out of bounds, but there again, the Eagles going to the left side of their formation, looking for the streak route down that sideline. This time they hit it, and they're inside Oriole territory at the 38-yard line. Here is Mikasel. He'll take the ball. He'll go left side. He'll elude a tackler, and he will end up going out of bounds at around about the 30-yard line.
Yeah, Zionsville's just mixing things up here a little bit, taking what they could get. They obviously saw something in the film study again, because they have attacked that left side pretty consistently here tonight. Did it short early in the first half. They've done it deep here a couple of times in the second half, and they're back to running the football again like they did on the first drive.
So second down and a long two. Lichty back to pass. Looks, pressure comes. He eludes the pressure. Now he's flushed to the near side. He fires down, and he was looking for Ramsey to the near side. Good coverage by Scott Campbell, and Lichty's forced to throw it away. That's going to bring up third down and about 2-3 yards to go.
Yeah, did a great job of scrambling. Had some time, but when it broke down, he stepped up in the pocket, broke contain and got outside. There just really wasn't anybody open, and he was smart enough to throw the ball in the dirt.
So third and two, make it 3 yards to go. The ball spotted at the 31-yard line for Lichty and the Eagles. Mattingly in motion. Pressure comes as they give the ball to Mikasel. Mikasel is going to be shy of the first down. He looked like he might have had a hole, but then his blocker kind of blocked him out of the where he wanted to go, and he's going to be shy of the first down, and that's going to make it fourth and about a yard.
Yeah, no doubt they're going to go for it here. I mean, if they get a score here, they can make it interesting. They've got the quarter, so they've got a chance to talk it over.
We will switch ends and head to the fourth quarter. Your score after three, Avon leads Zionsville 35-14. Back with the fourth quarter after this. This is Oriole football on ASO.
McNamara Florist is Indy's hometown florist since 1954, with 8 convenient locations, including the new Avon store on Rockville Road. McNamara Florist is famous for our floral designs for all occasions that help our clients express their emotions through flowers. Visit McNamara Florist for outstanding personal service and to select from the renowned home decor merchandising, including stunning Christmas classics. McNamara Florist is located at 9655 East Highway 36 in Avon, and you can give them a call at 579-7900.
We'd like to thank Citywide Paving for their support of Avon football and our Avon football broadcast this year.
Alongside the Indiana Football Hall of Famer Dave Shelburne, I'm Brian Scott. Fourth quarter about ready to get underway from St. Vincent Health Field at Zionsville High School. And the Avon Orioles lead the Zionsville Eagles 35-14. Avon took the ball right down the field their first two possessions of the second half. But they've watched Zionsville put up a touchdown, and now they have a fourth in about a yard. It is a direct snap. Lichty will take it left side, and he will get the first down as he simply took it over the left side himself down to the 25-yard line. And the Eagles will convert on fourth down, and they'll have it first and 10 at the Oriole 25-yard line.
Yeah, no doubt about it there. Easily picked up the first down, kept their drive alive.
They will have trips to the right side, a single wide out to the near side. Lichty, play action, back to pass. He fires. He's looking for the corner, and he will throw it, and penalty flags in the end zone. Pass is incomplete. Two Oriole defenders, and it looks like one bumped into the intended receiver before the ball got there.
Yeah, well, they were both deep. They were in man coverage. You know, anytime you see the back number of a defensive back, he's beat, and that's what happened in that case.
So pass interference called against the Orioles. I believe that's their third one tonight. Take it 15 yards further down the field for the Eagles, and they'll have it. When all is said and done, the ball will be spotted at the Oriole, just inside the Oriole 13-yard line, first and 10 for Zionsville. Just underway, fourth quarter. Avon leads by 21, but the Eagles scored on their last possession, and they are threatening here.
Man coverage again and no safety, so they're coming after it here.
They bring Mattingly in motion. They will throw to the corner, passes out of bounds. Coverage over there, but the receiver was well out of bounds.
That's the right route and the right call. The receiver just unfortunately didn't line up to give himself enough room to allow for the physical coverage down the field. And, you know, they still continue to go at that right side of Avon's defense, and again, good call, not a bad throw. He just didn't give himself enough room to, go up and make the catch.
Tentative receivers, Jay Edwards, Brian Fitzgerald in coverage.
Same defense.
Second down and 10. Same defense, except they're going to bring the pressure. Lichty steps up, and he's going to go down.
Ball's got to come out of his hands sooner when they're bringing that many people. And, they weren't hiding it. They showed it right away. Here we come. We're bringing the house. We're playing man coverage. They played it about 2 yards off the line of scrimmage. So, in that one, you catch the ball and throw it. Otherwise, you're going to end up with a sack like you just did.
A.J. Elcock with his second sack of the night drops Lichty back at the 21-yard line. That'll set up third down and about 13 yards to go. Eagles need to get it to the three if they want a first down.
Well, they're doing it again. I mean, Coach Bomby, you know, he gets set in his philosophy. Something works. Here they come again.
They will hand it off to Mekasol, and Mekasol will pick up maybe a yard or two, but he's going to be brought down as coming in to make the play. A.J. Alcock, he just got the sack, and as he was on his way to the quarterback, he just decided to grab the running back while he was there, and he brings Mekasol down after a gain of only a yard, and now fourth down. And looks like Coach Echeverria, he's going to bring the field goal unit on. So down by 21, they're going to bring the field goal unit on as Ryan Stein is going to kick this one. He was kicking into the wind before the second half. This will be a 32-yard field goal attempt. Good snap, good hold, almost blocked. The kick is on its way, and the kick is no good, off to the right. Had plenty of leg into the wind, but the kick was off to the right. Orioles have been getting close to the football all night long on kicks. They've blocked a punt tonight, and this one Stein sends wide right, and the Orioles keep the Eagles off the scoreboard. With 10-10 left to go, fourth quarter, Avon retains their 21-point lead, 35-14, and now have the ball first and 10 at the 20-yard line. And the give is just right up the middle. On first and 10, a pickup of about 3 yards by Corey DePriest. And make it four, as they'll say, they'll give Corey up to about the 24-yard line.
Yeah, so I think we've got Meisner in the game here now, too.
Take a look, see if Harrison Weber is to the near side. DePriest is the tailback. As the play clock winds down to six, it is Peters. He gives it to DePriest. DePriest makes a cut, turns it upfield. He'll take it out to about the 27-yard line. So if Meisner was in there, he was in there for one play as Brandon's back out for that second down play, and he's getting the play from the sideline.
Yeah, actually, I don't know how he got away with that. He and Andrew are both wearing number 15. I'm aware of it. Evidently, the refs weren't aware of it.
So it'll bring up third down in about three as the Orioles have three wideouts, two to the top. DePriest remains the tailback. And Brandon will simply give it to Corey. Corey will look for some room, and he has the first down. And there goes Corey, and he is not going to be caught. Corey DePriest is going to break off a 73-yard touchdown run. And the Orioles, with a big, big run from Corey DePriest, he got through. And once he was in the defensive second line of the Eagle defense, nobody was catching him. And he breaks off a 73-yard touchdown run.
Yeah, very, very well blocked. Avon's offensive line starting to wear down that defensive front of Zionsville. And, you know, once Corey got through, you're right, there was no catch. So nice, nice play, nice run.
So Sam Perino, who is perfect on the night and extra points. Gets this one away, and Sam will remain perfect. 8:29 left to go in this football game, and the Orioles have blown it wide open. They lead Zionsville 42-14. Back with a kickoff in a moment. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Avon Dental Center is a proud sponsor of Avon High School sports broadcast. Dr. Timothy Greer and Dr. Christopher LaFave have served Hendricks County families for over 20 years. Located in Avon's Beechwood Center area just east of Ivy Tech, they're open Monday through Friday, although early morning hours are available. Avon Dental Center offers high-tech dentistry that includes dental implants, orthodontics, and one-appointment crowns. At Avon Dental Center, their priority is to deliver quality care to informed patients in a comfortable and convenient setting. You can get more information at avondentalcenter.com or call for an appointment at 272-8100. Avon Dental Center.
Corey DePriest breaks off a 73-yard touchdown run. Sam Perino tacks on the point after. And with 8:29 left to go in this football game, all Avon, they lead Zionsville 42-14. This was a 21-7 game at the half, but the Orioles came out with a mission to begin the second half. They watched Zionsville put a touchdown on the board in the third quarter and looked like they were on the move to maybe score here again, but they tried to go for a field goal instead. The field goal was no good, and a few plays later, DePriest is running in the defensive secondary on his way to the end zone, and the Orioles have blown this one wide open now, 42-14, as Trevor Lichty and the Zionsville offense return to the field. At times, this Eagle offense has moved the ball fairly well. We can see how Brendan Michael, again, one of the top running backs in the HCC, though the Orioles have really bottled him up fairly well tonight. But the Oriole defense, when it has come down to it, especially on fourth down conversions and some when they need a big play, this Oriole defense has stepped up tonight. Lichty, they'll set up that bubble screen again, and they will get it out to the receiver Holden Hodge, and Hodge will pick up a couple of yards, but really, I can't really think, Coach, of too often that that play has worked tonight for the Eagles.
It hasn't. I think that's one of those things. They're trying to figure out a way to come up with a big play. They're not quite fast enough to just run by Avon. So, you know, they're having a little trouble with the running game, breaking anything big. So I think they're just looking for an opportunity to hit a big play and thought that might be their best opportunity.
Here's the pitch to Michael with Mattingly with the lead block, and Michael will take it up to about the 29-yard line. He'll be a yard shy of the first down.
Yeah, Avon's starting to sub here just a little bit. Looks like they've got Darnell Tolliver in the secondary. Davian Porter looks like he's in there at safety a little bit. So, they are getting a couple of their other seniors in here, especially giving them an opportunity to play.
And Cameron Meisner is warming up on the Avon sideline, so expect him on the next offensive series as Michael. He'll bounce it outside, and there's Brian Fitzgerald with a nice open field tackle to keep Michael from breaking that one down the sideline, but it is a first down for the Eagles. Ball will be spotted at the Zionsville 37-yard line, where they'll have it first and 10, and the clock will move once they set the chains. It does with 7:15 left to go in the football game. Avon up 42-14. Eagles with trips wide to the near side, one receiver to the far side. Lichty, play action. He will fire near side. Pass is complete. And Brody Goode's going to make a tackle. Penalty flag comes out immediately. Eddie Mattingly with the reception.
Must have got a face mask.
Let's see what this is about. I thought Brody had him rather low, but maybe he got a hand up there. And it was made right as soon as Brody made contact. So let's see what the call is here. Five-yard face mask called against versus Avon. And tack on 5 yards, and it'll be a first down with the ball spotted at the Oriole 49-yard line, first and 10, Zionsville. So they'll stack them left and right. Now they'll send Mattingly in motion once again.
Shovel.
Here's Lichty. They were looking for either the option or the shovel. He'll fire over the middle and a dangerous pass. As the Orioles defended that well, as Coach said, they were looking for that shovel pass to Mattingly on the motion, but the Orioles covered it up well, and then he tried to fire it further downfield. I think John Ramsey was intended receiver, but well played by Avon all the way through.
It is. Normally on that, you give your quarterback the out. You tell him if it's covered, you just hit the receiver in the foot, you know, and then take an incompletion and go back and call another play. For some reason, he hung on. There just wasn't any other place to go. They're lucky they didn't end up with Lyman downfield.
Here's Lichty. He will fire near side. Pass is complete. Taking it down to about the 40-yard line of Avon is Brock Bishop. Makes the catch at the 39-yard line and needed 10, got pretty much exactly 10 yards, and They'll move the chains at the Avon 39-yard line, first and 10, 6:38 left to go.
Yeah, Avon will give that up for the rest of the game. You know, if they want to run a little five-yard outs and take time off the clock, that's fine.
Lichty, same play, same result, and 5 yards is pushing him out of bounds.
Yeah, it might drive you crazy, and you'll get people screaming from the stands. But, you know, as from a coaching point of view, you know, complete 15 of those, the clock will be done. We're 135-14 or 42-14 and go home.
Tolliver pushed Bishop out of bounds, and this time they will move some players around and split the wide receivers left and right with four wide outs. Mattingly in motion, play action. Lichty fires, looking to go deep, overthrows his intended receiver, Scott Campbell, in coverage. Looked like he was trying to hit Jay Edwards, but well overthrown. Campbell had pretty good coverage on Edwards, and that will bring up third down and about three for the Eagles.
Yeah, right now if you're Avon, you want to stay healthy and you'd like to get a few of your seniors in there, give them an opportunity. A couple of your backup kids to get a little varsity time just in case you might have to use them down that tournament run. If you're Zionsville, you want to finish up on a positive, so they're going to do everything they can here to move the ball down the field and score.
Lichty throws it. Edwards goes down and gets it. Or not Edwards, that is Brock Bishop.
I understand the philosophy on both sides here. I mean, if you're Avon, fine, like I mentioned. If you're Zionsville, you know, you get a nickel and dime. You know, they're smart enough to know they're not going to win this game. But, you know, they like to get a score. They like to get their offense clicking here a little bit so they can move forward with the rest of the year.
It is first down for the Eagles at the Oriole 26-yard line. First and 10. Lichty back to pass over the middle, pass in and out of the hands as Davion Porter was concentrating on the receiver. If he looked up, he probably had the football right in his hands, but it goes incomplete. It'll bring up second and 10.
Yeah, really, really a nice throw. Put the ball on the money, and the receiver, for whatever reason, just wasn't able to bring it down, but a very well-thrown football.
Eddie Mattingly, the intended receiver for the Eagles, he'll come out as the Eagles will have second and 10 with three wide outs to the right. Orioles show blitz. They'll throw near side, same result, as this time they send it to the near side. Kyle Whitlock makes the catch. He is knocked out of bounds by Darnell Tolliver, a gain of about four on the play. That'll bring up third and 6.
You know, and again, who cares? You know, what Darnell doesn't want to do here is bite up, get bad, get anxious, get overly aggressive. I mean, if he wants to complete that pass a few more times, fine. Just don't give up the score.
So third and 6 for the Eagles. They'll keep this same formation they've been running the last 6 plays. As Lichty back to pass, pump fake, double move, and this time well overthrown as the intended receiver, I believe Whitlock once again, he was locked up with Darnell Tolliver. This time made a bit of a double move. Tried to get behind Tolliver. He was looking, Whitlock, I think, was looking for a hold, but no call came, and the Orioles had safety help over top. So
I'm sure if Coach Bomby could be heard all the way from the other side of the field, he was yelling the same instructions that I've been saying into the mic here. Give it up. It doesn't matter. Don't let him get behind you.
Fourth down is the Eagles. Lichty will fire near side. Passes complete. And falling down, making the catch for the first down at the Oriole 14-yard line, I believe it was John Ramsey Jr., and he made a nice adjustment to the ball, managed to catch it while falling down, and it was just enough to give the Eagles a first down. But the clock continues to move as we're under 6 minutes left to go in the game, and Avon well out in front, 42-14.
Blitz coming here. They're in tight coverage.
Lichty, he'll look for the corner. He'll fire it up in the end zone, and the ball comes out, but they say touchdown. Now the official's going to talk about this. Didn't look like he brought that down. Incomplete. Now they talk it over because the official originally called touchdown, but he didn't look like he had control of that on the way down. And he checks with the back judge, and the back judge says no, and the pass is incomplete. It'll be second and 10. And if I can see that from way up here.
You would think. Blitz coming again here.
Mattingly in motion. Second and 10. This one is given to Mikasel. Mikasel finds a big hole, and he will rumble into the end zone from 15 yards out. And the Eagles are on the scoreboard once again as Brendan Mikasel with his second touchdown. As Mikasel runs it in from about 15 yards out, and with 5:35 left to go in the fourth quarter, and the Eagles have put a score on the board as Ryan Stein on for the point after. Again, the Orioles very close, but Stein gets it through, and 5:35 left to go in the football game. The lead is cut to 21 for the Orioles. Come back with a kickoff in a moment. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Avon has a rich wrestling tradition, and now Red Cobra Wrestling is proud to be a part of it. Opening last November, Red Cobra Wrestling offers training sessions run by nationally known coach Chad Red. Red Cobra Wrestling is located at 9233 East Highway 36 in Avon, across the street from Walmart and behind sidelines in the Red Brick Building. Red Cobra Wrestling offers sessions for all ages, including third grade and under and fourth grade and up. Learn more about prices, class schedules, and information at RedCobraWrestlingAcademy.com.
Brendan Mikasel from 15 yards out gives the Eagles their second touchdown of the second half. And what was a 21-7 Avon lead has been a 21-14 game here in the second half. But the Orioles are still up three touchdowns with only 5:35 remaining in this football game. And they have the hands team out front. And this will be a low-line drive that will be taken out of thin air as Scott Campbell. That is great hands by that young man, because that was a line drive kick that he just basically plucked out of the air and advanced it to about the 40-yard line. So Campbell will give the Orioles field position at the 41-yard line, and Cameron Meisner and the offense is on the field. So it is a 6'1", 185-pound sophomore at the helm of the Orioles. As Meisner hands the ball off, this is Darian Love. And Love is going to pick up 10 yards, maybe 11 yards on first down. And it will likely be a steady dose of Darian Love here, as the Orioles look to close this one out and head back to Hendricks Regional Health Stadium for the season finale next week against the Millers of Noblesville.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity to get some of your other kids in here as well. I mean, the starters came in the third quarter, did what they had to do, reestablished things, got the momentum back, and now some of these other kids have practiced hard all week and all summer, get an opportunity to get in a varsity game here and, you know, have some stories to tell and some memories for when they get a little older.
There's Darian Love, and he had 10 on the first carry, and he picks up about 14 on the next carry. And just like that, the Orioles are down to the Eagle 34-yard line with the clock moving. Well, the clock stopped as they move the chains, but once it does, we'll be under 5 minutes left to go here in the fourth quarter. Other players into the game right now for Avon. Connor McCandless is in. Chad Carmichael is also in. Andrew Buis also into the game. We've seen a lot of Andrew in the JV games and getting some varsity minutes. Here is Darian Love, and Love running hard. That's a pickup of about 7 on the play down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line.
Yeah, you got some of those backup linemen in there doing a nice job. You know, they're fired up. They're getting an opportunity to play. And, you know, they're coming off the football here, you know, pretty hard for the end of the game.
Well, how often will you see two freshmen leave a game?
Right, and have some older kids come in and replace them.
And you're having some older kids replace them, because that's just what happened. DJ Bowles and Addison Batten have come out. As we approach the four-minute mark, second and 3 for Avon as Meisner waits the snap, gives it to Love. Darian, he will churn forward, and he's going to be caught from behind on a nice play. Might pick up a yard or two at the most. But it'll be third down and about maybe a yard and a half to go for Avon as the clock continues to churn here in the fourth quarter. Under 4 minutes, approaching 3:40 left to go in this final period of play.
Yeah, other than the kids on the field and their parents, everybody else, I think, wants this game to end so they can get on the bus and go home. But it is a thrill, I can tell you, for the kids that don't get to play much, for all the hard work and all the time they put in to get an opportunity to get in a varsity game like this is a thrill they'll never forget.
Luke Allen also into the game now for the Orioles at a wide receiver, but this is Love. He has a first down, and he'll be tripped up as he hits the 20-yard line. First and 10, Avon. Adrian Lozano, we see, is into the game, a 6-foot, 225-pound sophomore at tight end. Then mentioned Luke Allen, a senior in at wide receiver. And we're seeing a whole bunch of new numbers, but the one number that is still there from the varsity first teamers, that is Darian Love, as he is getting a heavy dose of the carries here on this drive. In fact, that has been the only person to touch the football other than Cameron Meisner. And here is Love. He'll bounce it outside. Darian will take it, and he will take it into the end zone from 20 yards out. So Darian Love was the only player to pretty much touch the football for Avon on that drive. He does it all by himself. He scores from 20 yards out. And the Orioles are going to be up once again by four touchdowns. As Sam Perino will try to remain perfect on the night. He will get this ball up. He'll get it through. And with 2:45 left to go in this football game, Avon out in front, 49-21. Back with a kickoff in a moment. This is Oriole Football on ASO.
Reynolds Body Shop is a proud sponsor of Avon Football Broadcast. They are conveniently located at 4325 West Washington Street in Indianapolis, just four stoplights east of 465. Their phone is 317-243-2372, and they are open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Reynolds has been family-owned and operated for 30 years, specializing in collision repair. Reynolds Body Shop is also an insurance work specialist. Learn more about them on the web at www.reynoldsbodyshop.com.
It was a 60-yard drive by the Orioles, and Darian Love was responsible for all 60 of it, including the final 20 yards that hit pay dirt, and the Orioles are back up in front by four touchdowns, 49-21, with 2 minutes and 45 seconds remaining. Alongside Dave Shelbourne, I'm Brian Scott. Sam Perino has had a workout tonight, gives this one a ride, and it will be taken at the goal line to the 5-10. And brought down at about the 18-yard line. I believe that was Brock Bishop. And it will be first and 10 for the Eagles. And it looks like Bishop is not too... is making his way to the near sideline, Gimpley.
Yeah, that's what you don't want to see, especially this late in the game. You know, this game is over. You don't want to see one of your good kids. You don't want to see anybody get hurt, but, you know, especially one of your starters.
So Bishop is limping over to the near sideline as the Eagles have a pair of timeouts and 2:40 left to go in the fourth quarter. Lichty, he'll throw right side.
Is that that looks like a new quarterback?
It is. That is Will Caldwell Jr., 6'1", 180-pound senior on senior night, getting a chance to play. So with the final 2:37, Coach Echeverria getting his seniors in on senior night, their final home game in a game that's decided. So going to get all his seniors in to get some playing time here to wind up the game. He'll hand the ball off and running it right up the middle and gaining a first down for It's a first down as, again, very difficult to see these numbers up here from Avon there, or for Zionsville. They're wearing all green and only the numbers are in outlined white. So tough time to pick up the numbers here. It is a first down. They'll hand the ball off once again, look for some room around the right side, and picking up a few yards on the play. I believe that was Alon Favors is with the ball carry. He's a 5'7", 152-pound junior. And again, now a whole bunch of defensive changes for Avon. Second and six. Under 2 minutes left to go as the clock is moving, and Caldwell will fire right side, and it'll be batted down there at the line of scrimmage. Getting a big paw up there was Jacob Otto, a 6'1", 210-pound senior defensive end, to knock that ball down from Caldwell. That'll stop the clock with a minute 53 left to go in the game and bring up a third down and about six for Zionsville. It was a big start to the third quarter as Caldwell's pass incomplete, as his intended receiver was Matthew Wirtz. Ball was high and incomplete, and it looks like the Eagles will punt this ball away to Avon and let Avon run this game, run this ball out and end this football game. It was the first two drives of the third quarter that really put this game away for the Orioles. They led by 14 at the break, though it wasn't a very pretty game. Here's a nice punt. Fair catch called for. It'll take a bounce, and it'll be finally knocked down about the 37, 38-yard line. We'll keep it here as the Orioles will likely just run this one out. But it was the first two drives of the second half for Avon. They scored touchdowns, and they scored them rather easily. They really put this game out of reach. The Eagles had managed to get a couple of scores, but each time the Orioles have pretty much answered that. The last one with the entire Orioles second team offense out there, with the exception of Darian Love, and Love was the only one to touch the ball. He accounted for all 60 yards on the drive, including the last 20, to make this a four-touchdown advantage. Meisner hands the ball off, and swallowed up in the backfield was the ball carrier for Avon. That was David Knezovic, 5'10", 165-pound junior, that ran the ball for a loss of about two as the clock makes its way down to a minute 14.
Yeah, Coach Bless and his staff got done the second half with they needed it and wanted to get done. Avon came out, played with a lot more fire, executed a lot better, played with a little bit more enthusiasm the third quarter. They just dominated and took charge like, you know, we kind of hoped, I guess, they would in the first half.
Meisner's going to take a knee, and the officials will let this one get to under 50 seconds and slowly mark the ball, and the Orioles can take one more knee, and that'll be good. Matter of fact, officials making sure to take plenty of time off before marking the ball. And Meisner will take a knee, and the Orioles, after a very sluggish and not a very pretty start to this football game, blew it open in the second half as the offense came alive and ran away from Zionsville. Meisner takes a knee. That's going to do it as the final 15 seconds will march off the clock here at St. Vincent Health at Zionsville High School. Final score, the Avon Orioles defeat Zionsville 49-21. We'll come back with some final thoughts and get ready for the season finale next week against Noblesville. This is Oriole football on ASO.
Changes Home Care is a proud sponsor of Avon High School football broadcast. Changes Home Care assists the elderly in staying independent in the comfort of their own home as long as possible. They assist individuals with bathing, dressing, transportation, medication reminders, lighthouse keeping, companionship, and much more.
Their office is on Shiloh Professional Drive in Avon. Changes Home Care serves Hendricks and Marion County as well as all of the surrounding counties. Their services are available 24/7, 365 days a year. For a consultation appointment, call area code 317-271-3800. That's area code 317-271-3800. Changes Home Care in Avon.
Avon Orioles knock off the Zionsville Eagles 49-21. That's our final here from Zionsville High School. Alongside Dave Shelbourne, I'm Brian Scott. This game was, as we said in the first half, if anybody told us this would be a scoreless game after one quarter, we wouldn't believe it. Coach, I think when we take a look at what the final score is, we kind of believe that.
Well, this is what we expected. Avon came out and played a dominant quarter in the third quarter, just played great, played the kind of football that we've seen them play a lot of the year. I think, mostly the first quarter, or maybe just going through the motions a little bit, just not quite getting into it. You get on the road, sometimes it happens. Today is the first day of fall break. I'll come up with every excuse I can here for them, I guess, for the first quarter. Second quarter, they put up 21 points and made a few big plays. And, I mentioned earlier that they needed a big play to get them started. And Brian Fitzgerald, came up with the punt return and got them going. And, we ended up with the two passes to Matt Moore to finish up the first half. In the third quarter, it was the Avon team that we kind of expected to play. And they came out and got after it. At the same time, hats off to Zionsville. They came in with a good game plan. They played hard the first quarter. And, as the game wore on, it was just pretty evident to everybody that they were just outmanned. Avon was a better team. And when Avon decided to, kick it up a notch and get it into third gear, they did the things that they were capable of doing and ended up dominating the game, I guess the way we all expected that they would do from the start of the game. But from the start of the second quarter to the end of the game, I thought they performed pretty well.
For as long as Zionsville actually had the football, it seemed at times, the Avon defense, they gave up some yards, especially you look at the opening drive of the football game where Zionsville pretty much marches it right down. They're at the goal line, fourth and short, but Avon came up with some big fourth down plays. They come up with some good special teams plays. Zionsville, they kind of shoot themselves in their foot with some penalties, but the Avon defense, when it needed to make a big play, it made a big play, and the Oriole offense, kind of once it got itself rolling, couldn't really be stopped.
Well, once it got going, it was a performance that we expected. Avon's defense has been pretty solid most of the year. If they've had a letdowns occasionally, they give up a big play. But, tonight they played hard. I think the front plays hard. I think their linebacker core is as good as you're going to find in the state of Indiana. They get after it. They run down plays and make tackles. And offensively, our skills are off the charts. I've coached football in the state of Indiana, for over 40 years, and Brandon Peters is as good a quarterback as I've seen at the high school level. And, Matt Moore and Andrew Griffin, I don't see, anybody, around here, haven't seen anybody for a lot of years that can compare to those two. And the offensive line continues to get better, and, they complement it with, Jordan Peterson and Harrison Weber. And, we mentioned the three running backs, so they've got a lot of weapons on offense. They've got good depth on defense. When the special teams are clicking, Sam Perino's a good kicker, and when they do all the little things that they're capable of doing, Avon's got a great football team and a chance to make a great run, once the tournament comes around.
Brandon Peters finishes the night with four touchdown passes. Corey DePries had a 73-yard touchdown run. Darian Love, he had a 20-yard touchdown run for Avon, but it was really Peters to Moores for most of the night. But it was really started off by Bryant Fitzgerald's 43-yard punt return for a touchdown, and the Avon Orioles go on to win this game by the score of 49-21. The win improves Avon's record to 6-2 on the season. They are now 4-1 in the Hoosier Crossroads Conference. The loss drops Zionsville to 3-5 on the year and winless in the HCC at 0-5. Avon returns home for their season finale next week at Hendricks Regional Health Stadium. They will take on the Noblesville Millers, who were getting pretty much shellacked by Brownsburg tonight. The Orioles, they still have an outside chance for a possible HCC co-championship, but like they did last year, they're going to need a little bit of help. This time, they're going to need their arch rival Brownsburg to help next week, as the Bulldogs will take on Hamilton Southeastern at Victory Field. A loss by Southeastern and a win by Avon means they'd be co-champions. But right now, I'm sure Coach Mark Bless, all he's concerned about is beating Noblesville and getting ready for sectionals. We will find out who the Orioles will play. The sectional pairings will be announced on Sunday. We'll try to keep you up to date with who the Orioles are going to play and where they play as we get ready for football. The regular season finale next week. We'll have that game right here for you on Audio Sports Online. Pregame at 6:30, and the kickoff between the Orioles and the Millers is at 7 o'clock. Avon Oriole Football on Audio Sports Online has been brought to you by Reynolds Body Shop, McNamara Florist, Avon Dental Center, Changes Home Care, Red Cobra Wrestling, and Citywide Paving. Avon Varsity Football is an AudioSportsOnline.com production.